This song. Test. 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 Test.
In the heart of Regency Furniture Stadium. Good evening, baseball fans. I'm Jim Paraboki, and welcome to the Regency Furniture Southern Maryland Blue Crabs pregame show. We're about 15 minutes or so away from the first pitch between the Sugar Land Skeeters and the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs here tonight at Regency Furniture Stadium. It's game three of this three-game set between these two clubs. The Blue Crabs come in on a seven-game winning streak as they beat the Skeeters yesterday morning by the final of 4-2. The Blue Crabs continued to have good offensive output as Anton DeJesus went 2-for-4 at the top of the order with 3 runs scored and an RBI. Renny Ozuna and Zach Wilson both going 1-for-3 and 1-for-4 respectively. Kyle Hankard continues to swing a hot bat, going 2-for-4 yesterday with 2 RBIs, while Gustavo Molina, speaking of swinging a hot bat, went 3-for-4 and didn't drive in anybody. But he went 3-for-4, and he's a guy who actually talked about with Stan Clyburn before the game here today and during Clyburn's corner, which you will hear in just a few moments, that you know, having him swing, in so many words, my words, not his, having him swing a good bat is so important to the offense of this club. Casey Stevenson went 1-for-4, and Casey Frawley went 1-for-4, the run scored at the bottom of the order as well. So, yeah, you know, again, 11 hits, the offensive output, hits-wise was there, runs-wise not so much, but the Blue Crabs winning yesterday 4-2. And a big reason for that is because of their pitching, and it was Brian Baker, the starter yesterday. He picked up his first win of the season. He went 7 innings, allowing 2 runs on 5 hits. One of those runs earned, striking out 3 and giving up a home run. But he picked up the win yesterday. Fernando Nieve got the hold. He went an inning of work, a clean inning. He only walked one guy, but did not give up any runs and any hits. And he also struck out one as well. Eric Hamrin, and then came in the ninth and picked up his 6th save of the season, going a clean 1-2-3 in the ninth inning. Shane Lukes took the loss yesterday, went 6 2/3, 4 runs, 10 hits, 1 walk, and he didn't strike down anybody, just didn't really get much run support as it was yesterday for the Skeeters. So the Blue Crabs in game 3 of this 3-game set will take on the Skeeters here tonight, looking for the sweep, which would be their second straight sweep, coming off a 4-game sweep of the Revolution last weekend, and trying to do the same thing except a 3-game sweep here tonight, and also looking for their 8th straight win. They will take on the Patriots right in the middle of this 7-game homestand. They'll take on the Patriots Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then Monday. And the Skeeters right now, having lost 5 of 6, they are reeling a little bit here, trying to figure things out after getting off to a pretty good start earlier on in the season. So they'll try to salvage a game here tonight away from the Blue Crabs, and in the process try to take one away and break that 7-game winning streak. Let's take a look at tonight's pitching matchup, and we'll start with Blue Crabs first, and it's right-handed pitcher Jake Hale. Hale 2-1, a 3.78 ERA here this season. 3 games pitched, 19 innings, 16 hits, 8 runs, 8 of them earned, 5 walks, and 10 strikeouts. He's won 12 games in his Atlantic League career. 0-2, though, against Sugar Land in his Atlantic League career. And Hale will be looking for his second straight win here tonight. His last appearance on the 8th against York, at York. He went 7 innings against the Revolution, allowing a run on 5 hits, striking out 2, did not walk anybody. He picked up the win, pitching beautifully that day against the Revolution. And on the other side, starting tonight for the Skeeters, is right-handed pitcher Sean Gallagher. Sean 0-1 on the season with a 1.57 ERA. He's gone 23 innings, he's allowed 12 hits, 5 runs, 4 of them earned, 4 walks, and 19 strikeouts. 4 games, 4 starts overall for Sean Gallagher, the 6-2 right-hander, 0-1, 1.57 ERA. So he will take the ball tonight for the Skeeters as his team tries to salvage a game in this 3-game set. Let's take a timeout. When we come back, we will talk with manager Stan Clyburn in Clyburn's Corner. That's coming up next on the Regency Furniture Southern Maryland Blue Crabs pregame show on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid.
Thank you for attending the Regency Furniture Stadium. First up, I'm just going to Sugar Land Skeeters. Leading off, right fielder number 5, Kevin Russo. Shortstop number 4, Peter Weeks.
Welcome back to the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs pregame show on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Time now for Clyburn's Corner, presented tonight by Pyrotechnica. We talked with Stan, as we always do, before the ball game. Blue Crabs manager about a various amount of topics here tonight, one of them including his starting pitcher yesterday, Brian Baker, who pitched beautifully, and of course, one of the big stories of his team right now at this point in the season, his offense. Clyburn's Corner is presented tonight by Pyrotechnica.
And the catcher number 7, Todd Jennings. On the mound for the Blue Skeeters tonight, the right-hander by the number 36, Sheldon Gallagher.
Welcome to Walmart.
Thank you.
Jeez. Jeez, I'm tired. Jeez Louise. And as always, we thank Stan for joining us on Clyburn's Corner, presented tonight by Pyrotechnica. We'll step aside when we come back. We'll have the starting lineups for you, your weather, your umpires, and we'll get you ready completely for first pitch between the Sugar Land Skeeters and the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. Game 3 of this 3-game set. It's coming up very shortly. You're listening to the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs pregame show presented by Regency Furniture on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Welcome back to the Regency Furniture Blue Crabs pregame show, and it's time now to take a look at tonight's starting lineups brought to you by Guardian Pest Control. First for the Sugar Land Skeeters, a team coming in with a record of 9-11 this game, number 21. Kevin Russo will lead things off. He is playing right field. Beamer Weems is the shortstop, and he bats second. Delwyn Young is the second baseman, and he is batting third. Chris Wallace cleans up batting fourth. He is the designated hitter. Justin Martin is the left fielder. He bats fifth. Denny Almonte is the center fielder. He bats sixth. Travis Scott is the first baseman. He bats seventh. Patrick Palmero is the third baseman. He bats eighth. Todd Jennings is the catcher, and he bats ninth. And on the mound is right-handed pitcher Sean Gallagher, 0-1, 1.57 ERA here this season. Taking a look at the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs starting lineup here tonight. It's not much different from last night's starting lineup. Fred Lewis is back in there here tonight. Anton DeJesus leads things off. He is playing center field. Renny Ozuna is batting second. He is the third baseman. Zach Wilson, the first baseman, is batting third. Kyle Hankard is the left fielder. He cleans up batting fourth. Gustavo Molina is the catcher. He bats fifth. Darrell Ward is the DH. He bats sixth. Fred Lewis, the right fielder, bats seventh. Casey Stevenson is the second baseman, and he is batting eighth. Casey Ferrale is the shortstop, and he is batting ninth. On the mound, right-handed pitcher Jake Hale, 2-1, 3.78 ERA here this season. Our starting lineups tonight brought to you by Guardian Pest Control. Blue Crabs in their white jerseys, white pants with blue lettering on their chest, blue numbers on the backs with white and blue caps with a dark blue brim, situated in the third base side dugout, managed by Stan Kleiber in his first season. And on the other side, the Skeeters tonight in their blue jerseys, gray pants, blue caps with a white emblem right in the center of their blue caps, black belts situated in the first base side dugout, and they are managed by Gary Gaetti in his fourth season. Our umpires here tonight, Drew Hoglund is behind the plates. Bill Worthington is the first base umpire. Christopher Kiersarski is the third base umpire. Outdoor Creations brings us our Regency Furniture Stadium field dimension. It's 310 down the left field line, 325 to the corner down the right field line, 375 to the alleyway in left center, 385 to the alleyway in right center, 405 from home plate to the 12-foot high fence covered by a dark green tarp in straightaway center field. The mini monster painted in green in left field with the manual scoreboard in the center painted in white. The big video board behind the mini grass hill in right field. Beautiful green grass in the outfield, beautiful green grass in the infield with a maroon gravel warning track surrounding the outer edge of the ballpark. Time for tonight's Honest Exterior Olympic Air weather reports. 69 degrees and sunny, winds southwest 2 miles per hour and 33% humidity. Just a beautiful, beautiful spring night for baseball. And by the way, before we end our pregame show here tonight, I want to give a quick, shout-out, if you will, to our grounds crew today. They did a phenomenal job. What happened was the sprinkler system went all haywire. It was set to go on last night about 5 minutes, five-minute intervals, I think. 5 minutes, that's the key. They were set to go on about 5 minutes, and the sprinklers right behind the infield went off, and they went off for hours throughout the night because the system went haywire. So the grounds crew with a couple of front office members and our two stadium operations guys, three stadium operations guys now, were out there digging up and trying to fix the field the best they could, and they have done a phenomenal job. It looks, the infield looks like a normal night, where the infield, as always, looks very beautiful. So great, great job by our grounds crew and the other front office members, including our three stadium ops guys, and Jason and Alex, ticket ops guys, who also helped with that process as well. Phenomenal job getting the infield ready, because this morning around 9:30, when I got in around 8:30, but I didn't notice it, but once I stepped up to the press box at around 9:30, and I got a chance to look out onto the field, and I said, whoa, I asked, did they do that on purpose? And somebody told me no. What happened was, the sprinklers just went off. The sprinklers just went off throughout the night, and they went on for a good amount of time to put puddles on the field. And of course, they had the diamond dig last week, so they've been working on the field, and I wasn't sure if maybe putting all that water on was part of the process, but it was not, and it was It was not part of the process. The issue was that the sprinklers went off. They went all haywire. And just a great job today by our grounds crew to get this field ready to go and ready for play here tonight. Both teams did not have batting practice out on the field. They did take batting practice underneath right outside the clubhouses today in the cage. So they did get their swings in today. But the field ready to go, and we're ready for just about ready for baseball. So, with that said, that does it for our Regency Furniture Bluecrabs pregame show. We will have the first pitch for you between the Sugar Land Skeeters and the Southern Maryland Bluecrabs in Game 3 of this three-game set next on the Southern Maryland Bluecrabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Got a chance to hear the tail end of that beautiful national anthem sung here tonight as the Blue Crabs have taken the field. Let's give you their starting defense. In left field is Kyle Henker. Anton DeJesus is in center field. Fred Lewis tonight is back in right after getting the night off last night. Renny Ozuna is the third baseman. Casey Frawley is the shortstop here tonight. Casey Stevenson is the second baseman. Zach Wilson is the first baseman. Gustavo Molina is behind the plate. And on the mound here tonight is right-hander Jake Hale. Jake 2-1 on the season with a 3.78 ERA. This is fourth start, 19 innings, 16 hits, 8 runs, 8 of them earned, 5 walks, and 10 strikeouts. Another right-hander throwing his warm-up tosses. It's a beautiful night, 69 degrees. There's been a lot of people that have come up to me today and have mentioned how beautiful the weather is, and I couldn't agree more. It is just a gorgeous, gorgeous night for baseball. Game 3 of this three-game set between the Skeeters and the Blue Crabs. Southern Maryland, of course, looking to win their 8th straight, 7-game winning streak, their longest of the season, while the Skeeters are reeling. They've lost 5 of their last 6. They're trying to start a new trend. Jake Hale finishing up his warm-up tosses. Sugar Land will send Kevin Russo, Beamer Weems, and Delwin Young to the plate. 1-2-3 in their order. Our first pitch tonight is presented by Charlotte Hall Veterans Home. Glad you're with us on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Intrepid, empowering business to communicate with clarity. And of course, we are glad you're with us on the YouTube side as well. So however you may be listening or watching, as always, we thank you. Kevin Russo, the right fielder, leading off, 242, 4 RBIs. Ready on righty, Hale kicks and fires. Called strike over the outside corner, and we are underway. Game number 3 of this 3-game set. Blue Crabs will take on the Patriots in a 4-game set this weekend. The 0-1. Now low, 1 ball and 1 strike. Blue Crabs 12-7. First place in the Freedom Division. Sugar Land right behind him in second place. 9-11 overall, 1-1. Swung on, popped foul off first. Wilson crossing into foul ground with room on the track. Makes a one-hand basket catch at the belt for out number one. Russo popping out weakly in foul ground. Here is Beamer Weems, the shortstop. Beamer at 347, two home runs and five RBIs. Leads the team with that 347 average. 12 hits on the season. Right-handed stick against the right-hander, Jake Hale, who stands at 6'7", 205 pounds, 29 years of age, 19 career professional wins. Turns, kicks, and the first offering. Inside, and that got a piece of Weems' front left shoulder, and Hale upset with himself as Weems flips the bat towards first and jogs down the line. One on one out. In a scoreless top of the first, and that'll send Delwin Young to the plate. Switch hitting second baseman, Delwin, 235, one home run, and five RBIs. Hale 2-1 on the season. Fourth start here in 2015, sixth professional season. Came out of Ohio State University. Here's the pitch. Outside for ball one. He attended Ohio State University from 2006 to 2009. And he was then drafted by the Arizona Diamondbacks in 2009 in the 27th round. 1-0 the count to the switch hitting Young, batting left. The kick, the pitch. Fastball paints the outside corner, a strike. Nicely done by Jake Hale with that fastball, which, as we've seen before this year, has very, very good movement to it. Delwin Young trying to get hot at the plate. Young yesterday going 1-for-4. The 1-1 down the way. And it's two balls and one strike. Outfielders play straight away. Lights are on here at the ballpark. The outfielder is still in sunlight. The shadows across the grass in the outfield. The entire infield is covered in shadows. The lead by Weems over there at first base. Hale comes set, 2-1. Swung on, bounced over the mound to second. Stevenson gloves, flips the second one. Frawley's turn on the first is in time. 4-6-3, easy. Double. Scoreless bottom of the first. Here's how the Skeeters line up defensively. Martin is in left, Del Monte in center, Russo is in right, Palmero is at third, Weems is at short, Young is the second baseman, Scott is at first, Jennings tonight is getting the start behind the plate, Todd Jennings the catcher, and on the mound is right-hander Sean Gallagher, 0-1, 1.57 ERA. This is fifth start, 23 innings, 12 hits, 5 runs, 4 of them earned, 4 walks, and 19 strikeouts. The right-hander gets the left-handed hitting. DeJesus the pitch. Antone takes low for ball one. DeJesus, the center fielder, 211, one home run, and four RBIs. Quickly back in there. The turn, the kick, and the 1-0. Fastball, a called strike over the outside corner. It's 1-1. Yesterday, DeJesus went 2-for-4 with 2 doubles and 3 runs scored. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a pop foul off to the left and out of play. That's an important number to remember. 3 runs scored going 2-for-4. And we've talked about it with Stan Clyburn before on Clyburn's Corner, and I've talked to him about it off the air as well. And he has said that it's so important for DeJesus to get on because of the fact, 1-2, in tight, he can score runs, and as evident as yesterday, 3 runs scored. Perfect example of it. When he gets on base, he can steal, he's fast, he can really get around the base path. He's important. 2-2. Swing and a ground ball to short. Weems up with it, quickly slings on to first, and DeJesus is out number one. One gone. Here's Renny Ozuna. Sean Patrick Gallagher, 6'2", 220 pounds, 30 years of age, from Boston, Massachusetts. Features a fastball, a 12-6 curveball, and he'll mix in a slider as well. He's got one out. The number two hitter, Renny Ozuna, right-handed stick, the third baseman, 293, one home run, 5 RBIs. Here's the kick and the pitch. Swing and a pop foul off first. Scott crossing into foul ground onto the track and watches it twist out of play. It's 0-1. Gallagher was selected in the 12th round of the 2004 draft by the Chicago Cubs out of St. Thomas Aquinas High School in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. The 0-1 in tight, and backing off the plate is Ozuna. Nearly got his jersey. That's 1 ball and 1 strike. Gallagher wearing number 36 on his back. In his last start against Camden, took the loss that day. It was a bad loss for the Skeeters team. They fell 10-3, 1-1. Swing and a line drive back towards the middle and through into right center, a base hit. Went right over the head of Gallagher. And into right center field where Almonte fields it cleanly. And Ozuna responsible for the first Blue Crabs hit here tonight. He couldn't get into any sort of rhythm out there on the mound and really bring his best stuff. Wilson, the first baseman, right-handed hitter, 268, a homer, 5 RBIs. Here's the set position. One down, the pitch, up high. No score here in the bottom of the first on a gorgeous night here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Wilson, 3-for-8 here in the series, comes in on a 7-game hitting streak. Here's the set position by Gallagher. At the belt, now the 1-0. Swing and a line drive, laced into center field. That's down, a base hit. DeJesus fields it cleanly. Stopping at second is Ozuna. Back-to-back hits, and the Blue Crabs looking for an early lead. They've got 2 hits in a row, and now the number 4 hitter, Kyle Hankard, will step in. The left fielder, 4.12 average to lead the Atlantic League, 2 home runs and 8 RBIs. Gallagher, the right-hander, against the right-handed hitting Kyle Hankard, who bangs off his cleats with his bat, digs in back of the right-handed batter's box. Ozuna, good speed, takes his lead off second. Wilson, with decent speed, takes his lead off first, but remember, he is still a little bit gimpy with that injured right ankle. One down, here's the pitch. Slider, called strike, catching the outside corner. Good spin to it, good movement. And Hankard smartly taking it, not a pitch that he can really do anything with in terms of hitting it hard into one of the gaps, or maybe over the wall, as he did in game one of this series. Gallagher set from the belt, the 0-1. Breaking ball, a little bit low, 1 ball and 1 strike. Hankard deposited a 3-run home run over the mini monster and over the picnic area on top of the mini monster in the left field on Tuesday night in game one of this series. It was a 3-run shot. And it was exactly that, a shot in that 4-run fifth inning for the Blue Crabs. The 1-1. Cut on, foul tip held by Jennings behind the plate. And anchored a little bit in front of that slider there. It's 1 ball and 2 strikes. With Gustavo Molino waiting on deck. Scoreless here, bottom of the first. 2 hits in the inning for the Blue Crabs. Anchor digs back in. Relatively big hole on the right side. Young pinch towards second. The 1-2 on the way. Swing and a miss. And Hankard chasing a slider, just flailing at it. And that's the first strikeout for Gallagher. Two outs. Here is Gustavo Molina. Now, the way Molina has been hitting the last few games, he homered twice on Tuesday night, went 3-for-4 yesterday. Gallagher not out of the woods yet. Molina, 360 average, 6 home runs, 13 driven in, and that 360 average at one point, it was down below 200. In fact, it was down below 200 about a week ago at this time. But he has just gone on a tear. Here's the pitch. Fastball, called strike over the outside corner. Good frame job behind the plate by the catcher, Jennings. And it's 0-1 to the right-handed hitting Molina. He's 5-for-7 here in the series. 3 RBIs, a double, 2 home runs. And a nice job behind the plate defensively. 0-1. Down the way with a fastball. And it's 1-1. He comes into the game, Molina does. First in the league with 6 home runs. 12 RBIs in his last 9 games. 15th professional season for the veteran. A ball and a strike. Gallagher comes set. No score, bottom first. The kick and the pitch. Swung on. Cue shot, grounder, foul. Outside the line, first base side. And it's 1-2 now to Molina. Darryl Ward, who's been struggling a bit as of late, is waiting to hit next. Outfielders play straight away. Wind has died down to nearly nothing here at the ballpark. Great night for baseball here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Pretty nice crowd on hand to watch the Blue Crabs and the Skeeters do battle here tonight. Southern Maryland looking for their 8th straight win. The 1-2. Swinging a foul, straight back over the screen and out of play. Next pitch to Molina, and this at bat will be the 6th. Ozuna takes his lead off 2nd. Zach Wilson takes his lead at 1st. Gallagher leaning at the waist, arm dangling off his right side, left glove, glove tucked on his left knee. Brings those hands together. Looks down at the dirt. He kicks and fires. Swing and a broken bat, soft liner out to short, and a leaping one-hand grab made by Beamer Weems. It just kept diving, it was hit off the end of the bat, and it dove, pulling Weems a little bit off the dirt, but it dove as soon as he, into his glove, as soon as he leaped up, and then he made the catch. Blue Crabs with 2 hits, they leave 2, and at the end of 1 inning of play, it's the Skeeters nothing, and the Blue Crabs nothing. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by E-Trap.
Alright, somebody's looking for the Barrow Lottery Lucky Pick. Game receiver 5, here we go.
The 2nd inning, Skeeters Blue Crabs are scoreless here tonight at Regency Furniture Stadium. Game 3 of this 3-game set. Blue Crabs looking for their 2nd straight sweep and their 8th straight win here tonight. Skeeters coming in, having lost 5 of their last 6. Trying to salvage a game in this series. They went down in order 1-2-3 against right-hander Jake Hale on top of the 1st. Now it's Chris Wallace, Dustin Martin, and Denny Almonte. Wallace the DH, 304, 2 home runs, 9 RBIs. Here's the kick and the pitch. taken for a called strike at the belt over the outer third. Wallace, right-handed hitter against the right-hander Jake Hale. Here's the windup and the 0-1. Slider, low and away, one ball and one strike. Wallace, a former 16th round draft pick by the Astros in 2010. The wind and the 1-1. Swing and a miss. Got tied up on a fastball in the inner half. And it's one ball and two strikes. Wallace, a guy with 30 home runs. His first two seasons in the minors. And this was a guy that was drafted as a defensive first prospect. 1-2. Check swing. On the appeal. No swings. His first base umpire, Bill Worthington. On a pitch that was down and away. It's two balls and two strikes. So with those 30 home runs, the Astros got a nice surprise. 2-2. Swing and a miss. Head of a changeup. And Wallace down on strikes. That's the first K tonight for Jake Hale. And with one out, here's Dustin Martin.
Left fielder number 14, Dustin Martin.
Martin, the left fielder, 247. Two home runs, 10 RBI. Here's the windup and the first offering. A little bit low for ball one. Martin had his 13-game hitting streak snapped yesterday. 1-0. Outside, 2-0. Former 26th round draft pick by the Mets in 2006 out of Sam Houston State. No score here in the top of the second. 1-0. 2-0 pitch. Down and away, and it's 3-0, and I can see the frustration up here from Jake Hale. I remember after his first start against Long Island, I talked to him after the game. Ball game in which he walked one batter. Comes a 3-0. Taken for a called strike over the outside corner. And I asked him, I said, you know, you got really upset when you walked that one guy. Do you just walk guys? I'm sure that was kind of a stupid question. 3-1. Swing and a miss. And, I mean, look, every pitcher hates walking guys, but he said, yeah, I really, really hate walking guys. And he told me it very emphatically. So one thing that Jake Hale does not pride himself on is walking hitters. Doesn't mind if they make contact or how many guys he strikes out. He just doesn't want to walk anybody. The 3-2, up high, ball four. And he walks Martin, his first free pass issued here tonight. And as you can probably guess, none too happy about it. Now it's Denny Almonte's turn, the center fielder. One on one out, no score, top second. Almonte, switch hitter, batting left, 208, three home runs, and nine RBIs. The set position by Hale on the pitch. Change up outside. And now Jake is trying to find the strike zone. One ball and no strikes is the count to Almonte. Got that lime green sleeve on his left arm again here tonight. Black batting gloves. 1-0. Swing and a pop foul off to the left. And out of play. Skeeters managed by Gary Gaetti in his fourth season. A guy who played 20 seasons at the major league level. For the most of his career, he spent it with the Twins. Had a fine, fine career. 1-1. Outside, two balls and one strike. I was talking to someone in the front office about this the other day. I think you can make a case for Gary Gaetti and the Hall of Fame. We haven't talked about it the last 2 days, and it's a perfect night to talk about it. Because think about the numbers that he put up. 2-1. Swung on, pulled on the ground, foul of first. 255 career batting average. Okay, not great. But there are guys in the Hall of Fame with a lower batting average. 360 home runs. Maybe that number is a little bit low, especially for Gaetti, who was a third baseman. Over 1,300 RBI. And here's the kicker. Here's something that you have to take, I think, into consideration when a guy is borderline like Gaetti. Here's the 2-2, runner breaks for second. Pitch down low, Molina's throw to second a little bit wide to the right field side of the bag, and Martin slides in feet first safely. As Frawley, the shortstop covering, couldn't handle the throw. Stevenson there to back it up. It's a stolen base for Dustin Martin. His second of the season. He's in scoring position. And El Monte is apparently, he was called out. I didn't see the home plate umpire, Drew Hoglin, call him out on strikes. Or did he call him out on strikes? You know what? It might have been a catcher's interference. El Monte is gone, though. Get the official scoring on that in just a moment. Here's Travis Scott with two down. I didn't see a called third strike from Drew Hoglin, the home plate umpire. Here's the pitch. Hell deals a fastball, and it's grounded foul of first. Scott, the first baseman, 175 with three RBIs. Now, the kicker I was talking about with Gary Gaetti, 13-time Gold Glover and a .965 fielding percentage. And he did have 34 home runs in 1986, which, again, is 1 year. Okay. But I think the fielding percentage and the 13-time Gold Glover, you should take that into consideration. Here's a foul straight back to the backstop. Off the brick and right back towards the home plate area. Nothing in two of the count. Runner at second base and Dustin Martin. Two outs, top second, no score. Travis Scott, left-handed hitting first baseman. Patrick Palmeiro is waiting on deck. Outfielders are playing straight away. Hale comes set, checks the runner three times. He kicks and fires. Swing and a miss. And down goes Travis Scott. Second strikeout for Jake Hale. No runs, no hits, and one man left in scoring position. We head to the bottom half of the second inning. Skeeters, Blue Crabs, scoreless. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, presented by E-Trek. Darryl Ward will lead things off. Home half of the second inning, scoreless here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Sean Gallagher, the right-hander, ready to work. Here's the pitch. Ward takes a called strike right down the heart of the plate. It's 0-1, a fastball from Sean Gallagher, second inning of work. He allowed two hits in the top of the first. Blue Crabs unable to score. Working off the first base edge, he kicks and fires. Breaking ball down low to the left-handed hitting Darryl Ward, the DH tonight. And it's 1-1. Darryl, 226, two RBIs. Outfielders play straight away. The turn, the kick, next offer. Swung on, hit on the ground to first. Collected in by Scott. He calls off Gallagher and steps on the bag. Ward is retired for the unassisted putouts. Here is Fred Lewis. Lewis with the day off yesterday. Left-handed hitting right fielder. .241 batting average. With two RBIs. Digs in back of the left-handed batter's box. There's the windup and the pitch. Lewis takes a called strike over the outer third. Don't let the average fool you for Fred. He comes into the ballgame tonight, fifth in the league, with 11 walks, and he has hit in six of his last seven games. Here's a wave and a miss on a 12-6 breaking ball that he appeared to be fooled on. And it's nothing in two. Gallagher looking for his second strikeout. The turn, the kick, here's the two-strike pitch. Up high, good miss pitch, the fastball that time. And it's one ball and two strikes. Bottom half of the second inning, no score here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Game three of this three-game set. Skeeters and the Blue Crabs. Southern Maryland looking for the sweep here tonight. 1-2 on the way. In the dirt, 2-2. Bases are empty. On deck is Casey Stevenson. Wind has died down to nothing here at the ballpark. Lights are on. Pocket of sunlight in the alleyway in right center field. The outfielder's in the shade. The 2-2. He got him looking. Strike three. A fastball on the outer edge, and Lewis didn't like it. Begins to take off his batting gloves as he stands in the left-handed batter's box. Now walks back towards the dugout on the third base side. That's the second strikeout tonight. Sean Gallagher, two up, two down. Scoreless ball game, bottom of the second. Here's Casey Stevenson. U.S. Foods is one of the USA's leading distributors. Nearly $19 billion in revenue. U.S. Foods is the 10th largest private company in America. Stevenson swings and misses. And Gallagher is starting to feel it. As he is ahead 0-1, good fastball there from Sean, former major leaguer in his own right. Four seasons at the major league level. 0-1, called strike. Gallagher looking for the 1-2-3 inning. Third base edge, the 0-2. Up high off the mitt of Jennings to the backstop. And it's a ball and two strikes. Yeah, Gallagher, four seasons at the major league level with the Cubs, the A's, the Padres, and the Pirates. Drafted out of St. Thomas Aquinas High School in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. 1-2. Breaking ball, cut on, foul tip into the mitt of Jennings for the strikeout in the third of the ball game for Gallagher. Saying the Blue Crabs down in order in the process. 1-2-3, two innings in the books. Scoreless, Skeeters, Blue Crabs. You're listening to the Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Presented by Intrepid. Whose balls were they? Whose balls were they?
Oh, we have some baseballs there on the counter.
What'd you
Alex just threw them at the door when he went in the bathroom.
That's funny. On to the top of the third inning, scoreless here at Regency Furniture Stadium. The Sugar Land Skeeters and the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. 8-9-1 in the order for Sugar Land. Patrick Palomero, Todd Jennings, and Kevin Russo. Right-hander Jake Hale with three strikeouts in the ballgame. Palomero, the right-handed hitting third baseman. 294, one home run, which came on Tuesday night over the wall in left center. Eight RBIs. Here's the first offering. Patrick swings and misses through a fastball. It's 0-1. Chip off the old block, as they like to say, with Patrick Palomero, the son of Rafael Palomero. It's set in the box. Here's the windup and the 0-1 pitch on the way. Low and outside. It's one ball and one strike. It's interesting. He was a 22nd round draft pick in 2008 out of high school. Did not sign. Went on to UAB. Played college ball. 1-1. Now in the way. He didn't have exactly a spectacular career, but a very good career. But he wasn't drafted. In fact, when I say very good career, he did have 100 career hits at UAB. But he just went undrafted. The 2-1. Swung on, popped up in the air, foul off third. Molina and Ozuna giving it a look as it twists out of play into the first row behind the dugout. And it's now 2-1. And Palmeiro, instead of getting drafted, he actually signed as an undrafted free agent to the White Sox. But even with that, it just surprised me that he didn't get drafted again after getting drafted out of high school. This guy who can really swing the bat, working hard in the cage before the ball game underneath. Here's the windup and the 2-2 on the way. Swinging a foul straight back over the screen out of play, and we'll do it again. Yeah, 2-2. Todd Jennings, the catcher, is waiting to hit next. Hale on the first base edge of the rubber. Rocks, kicks, and fires. Swing and a line drive roped into left field. It's down a base hit. Hankert fielding it cleanly. And it's the first hit of the ball game for the Skeeters. Leadoff man on here is the catcher, Todd Jennings, who was not in the lineup last night, the number 9 hitter. Hitting under 100 with 2 RBIs. The exact Jennings 2-for-23 on the year. Palmeiro at first base does not have any swiped bags here this season. Outfielders play Jennings straight up. Hale comes set. Now he steps off the rubber, fakes the throw to first, and Palmeiro just falls back to the first base bag. Hale with a slight lean at the waist, looks over his left shoulder at the runner, Palmeiro. Brings the hands together. Now he kicks and fires. Fastball in there, a called strike across the knees to Jennings. Todd's 6 foot, 225 pounder, former second round draft pick by the San Francisco Giants out of Long Beach State. He made it to the AAA level in 2007 and then again in 2008. Quick throw to first, Palmeiro diving back in head first safely. No score, top third, nobody out. Jennings had a real nasty injury. In May of 2008, he was playing for the Fresno Grizzlies. And he was catching, and on a fly ball that Mitch Mayer was tagging up from third. Hale coming set. The 0-1. Low and outside with an off-speed pitch, 1-1. And Mayer, who was playing for the Omaha Royals at the time, banged so hard into Jennings on a collision at the plates on a sacrifice fly attempt that Jennings had torn multiple ligaments in his left knee, including his MCL, which also... With that collision, here's the next offering down low. Helped break his ankle as well, so he had a knee injury and an ankle injury. And really, both were nasty. Well, he recovered, but he had more bad luck. Because after the 2008 season, he tore a ligament in his right elbow while making a throw to second base, participating in off-season drills. He was eventually, of course, released by the Giants, and he's been playing independent ball since 2010. Here's a fastball, called strike over the outside corner. And now it's 2-2 here to Todd, so he's had some bad luck with some injuries, trying to battle back at times in his career. But at one time, he was a pretty promising prospect, Todd Jennings was, for the San Francisco Giants, again, a former second-round draft pick. Remember those collisions, though. They are some nasty, nasty injuries at times. The 2-2 on the way. Swing and a pop foul out of play to the right. I mean, you think about it. I mean, you remember Buster Posey a couple years ago when... I forget who the runner was. I'm trying to think. Well, anyway, when the runner ran from third base, ran into him at the plate, and he had a big-time leg injury. It was bad. Catching is a dangerous, dangerous position. And those collisions could be even more dangerous. 2-2. Swung on, bounced over the mound towards the middle. To his left, Raleigh. Gloves it near the bag. Flips the second one. On to first. The throw from Stevenson is in time. A double play. Nicely done. 6-4-3. With Raleigh gloving that one just in front of the second base bag. And a nice turn by Stevenson. Second double play here tonight, dished out by Jake Hale. And this Blue Crabs defense, at the end of the ball game, a 984 fielding percentage, tied for first in the Atlantic League, doing their job thus far. Back to the top of the order, here's Kevin Russo. The pitch. Fastball, taken for a called strike, clipping the outside corner. Bases are empty, two outs, no score, top third. Russo popped out to the first baseman, Wilson, his first time. The 0-1. Slider outside, one ball and one strike. On deck, if Russo were to reach, is Beamer Weems. Hale, first base edge. Rocks, kicks, and delivers. Swung on, hits sharply to short. Frawley, two steps to his left. He gloves and fires on to first. And with that, the Skeeters are down in order. 1-2-3. 2.5 in the books. Skeeters Blue Crabs scoreless on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Third inning. Glad you're with us here tonight on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Intrepid, empowering business to communicate with clarity. And of course, we're glad you're with us for those of you watching on the YouTube side as well. Scoreless ball game, Skeeters Blue Crabs. Sean Gallagher, another inning of work. The righty kicks and fires. A called strike to Casey Frawley. Right-handed hitting shortstop, leading things off. It'll be Frawley to Jesus Ozuna. Casey 228, the homer, 7 RBIs. The turn, the kick, and the pitch. Swung on, grounded to third. Palmeiro knocks it down the chest, picks it up on the grass, and slings on to first. Frawley out number one. Back to the top of the order here is Anton DeJesus. Anton grounding out to short his first time. Blue Crabs looking for their eighth straight win here tonight. Third meeting of 15 between these two clubs. Here's a fastball inside. Southern Maryland looking for their second straight sweep as well. 1-0. Jesus squares, pulls back, and takes a fastball high. And it's 2-0. Blue Crabs sweeping the York Revolution over the weekend, 4 games. Here's the turn, the kick, 2-0. Swing and a line drive into right. Russo coming on. It touches down onto the grass. A base hit. Third hit of the ball game for the Blue Crabs. DeJesus with good speed. A one-out base runner for Reddy Ozuna. Blue Crabs, a team that, during this 7-game winning streak, have outscored their opponents 46-22. And those 22 runs allowed the lowest mark in the Atlantic League over that span coming into the night. Scoreless here tonight, bottom of the third. Gallagher coming set. Ozuna right-handed hitter. Now quick throw to first and diving back in head first safely is DeJesus. Santone 4-for-4 in stolen bases here this season. Gallagher leaning at the waist, arm dangling off his right side. Now Sean comes set. He's down at the dirt. The pitch outside to Rennie. Ozuna yesterday 1-for-3. Heading the count 1-0. Outside target. From the belt, Gallagher. Long look, kicks and fires. Fastball, a strike over the outside corner. And it's 1-1. Three hits in the ballgame for the Blue Crabs. Gallagher has three strikeouts in the game. Southern Maryland has left two base runners on. Jesus at first taking his lead here. Relatively big lead. He's held on by Scott. Now a quick throw to first, and DeJesus diving back in head first safely ahead of the tag from Travis Scott. Ozuna, a guy hitting 318 here at home. Ninth professional season for Rennie. Now time called as Gallagher stepping off the backside of the rubber just as Ozuna was about to call time. Rennie drafted by the Texas Rangers in the 32nd round at New Mexico Junior College. Time called again. It looks like Gallagher is having trouble getting on the same page as his catcher, Jennings. Brings the hands together here. From the belt, the 1-1. Pitch out, fake snap throw by Jennings, chasing DeJesus back to the bag. And it's 2-1. Zach Wilson is waiting on deck. I will say this about DeJesus, because I keep one eye on him and one eye on the plate. And it appears that from up here, DeJesus is taking a pretty big secondary lead. From the belt, breaks for second. 2-1 is swung on and line down the right field line, slicing foul and out of play. Possible hit and run. And again, a pretty big hole for the most part. On the right side, Delwin Young, the second baseman. And we didn't see this in game one with the second baseman for Sugar Land, Zazueta. But we're seeing it with Young the last two games. He plays closer to the bag than a lot of second basemen, allowing that big hole to open up on the right side. DeJesus breaks again for second as the pitch is popped foul out of play to the right. Even when there's nobody on, Delwin Young is still relatively close to the bag. Here, not as close as he has been in the past, but he's playing just behind the baseline and pinched slightly towards the second base bag. Meanwhile, as I mentioned before, Scott is holding on to Jesus, so there was a pretty big hole in that right side. And if Ozuna gets a pitch on the outer half, he can just go the other way with it. The set position, the 2-2, DeJesus breaks for second. Check swing, throw to second base, tag, safe! Young covering the bag, DeJesus sliding in feet first safely. And on the appeal to first base, Bill Worthington, the umpire, saying that Ozuna went too far around on a pitch that was low. And Gallagher gets his fourth strikeout of the ballgame. Two outs and a runner in scoring position. DeJesus 5-for-5 this season in stolen bases. Zach Wilson singling his first time. He's 1-for-1, a runner in scoring position, no score, bottom third, two outs. Gallagher set belt high, he's down in the dirt, he fires, up high. Wilson hitting .333, 10-for-30 during this seven-game hit streak. Coming into the night, now an eight-game hit streak. With his single back in the first. 1-0 pitch. Waved at and missed. Nice breaking ball down low, and Wilson went fishing for it. 1-1. On deck is Kyle Hankard. Zach, fifth professional season. He was drafted by the Pirates in the 26th round in 2008 out of high school, and then by the Yankees in the 21st round out of Arizona State. 1-1. In the dirt, smothered by Jennings. drafted by the Yankees back in 2011. In fact, when he played in high school in the area code games in 2008, he got the opportunity to play one of his games in the old Yankee Stadium. A thrilling, thrilling time for Zach, who was just a senior in high school. The 2-1. Swing and a ball lifted foul, right side out of play. And it's 2-2, and of course, as luck would have it, wouldn't you know it, the 3 or 4 years later, he's drafted by the New York Yankees out of Arizona State. It's funny how some things work like that, right? Two outs, 2-2 the count, no score, bottom third. Here's the pitch. Down the way, full count. I say that because I remember I read Dustin Medroy's book once. And he got hit in the eye, I think it was, in college or something. And he was in a Boston airport because he went to go see a specialist in Boston. And he was not in a good mood because his eye hurt and he was injured and whatnot. He was going through the Boston airport saying hi to people. And, of course, as luck would have it, specialists in Boston who looked at him, here's a check swing, a called third strike, Wilson down on strikes. As luck would have it, of course, you go see a specialist in Boston, the town that you're going to play your major league career in and make a lot of money and have a fabulous career doing. That's baseball, right? Back-to-back strikeouts, Wilson caught looking, and five strikeouts in the game for Sean Gallagher. Blue Crab strand a runner in scoring position at the end of three innings of play. Skeeters Blue Crab scoreless on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Top half of the fourth inning, Skeeters Blue Crabs are scoreless here tonight at Regency Furniture Stadium. Blue Crabs, three hits. Skeeters with one hit. Jake Hale with three strikeouts in the ballgame. And he will toe the rubber for his fourth inning of work. It'll be the shortstop Weems to lead things off, followed by Delwin Young and then Chris Wallace. Hale, the right-hander, first base edge of the rubber. Rocks, kicks, and fires. Fastball up high. Weems hit by a pitch his first time up, right-handed hitter. Hale 2-1 on the season. 3.78 ERA. 1-0 pitch. High and tight. Two balls and no strikes. Hale was first drafted by the Cleveland Indians out of high school in the 2005 draft in the 24th round out of Alexander High School. 2-0 pitch. Swung on, line to third, cut at the chest by Ozuna, snagging that one out of the air. As Weems hit that right on the nose. He is out number one. Here is Delwin Young. Young grounding into a 6-4-3 double play his first time up. Hale was then drafted by the Blue Jays in the 20th round in the 2007 draft, and then the 27th round by the Arizona Diamondbacks his senior year in 2009 out of Ohio State University. The wind, the pitch, down low. Young switch hitter batting left. Hale into the motion, 1-0. Swung on, grounded sharply in the hole on the right side, out of the range of Stevenson. And into right field, a base hit. Second hit of the ball game for Sugar Land. Here's Chris Wallace, the DH. Hale spent two seasons in the Arizona Diamondbacks organization. Made as high as the high A level with Visalia pitching in three games over. The number five starter in this Blue Crabs rotation. Tomorrow, Brian Grenning will get the start for Southern Maryland in place of Brian Burris, who will miss another start with a strained forearm. Here's the pitch to Wallace, and Chris takes low. Fastball that time to the right-handed hitting DH, the cleanup hitter. Struck out swinging his first time up. Looks down at Gary Gaetti, his manager and third base coach. Digs back in right side, back of the batter's box. Straightaway stance. No score, top four. Here's the pitch. Fastball, called strike. Nice pitch on the outside corner with good movement. Nice frame job as well by Gustavo Molina. One ball and one strike is the count. Pretty big hole on the right side. Stevenson pinched towards the bag. Wilson holds on Young. 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball outside, two balls and one strike. Blue Crabs looking for their eighth straight win. The Skeeters have lost five of their last six. The last win coming on Monday against Camden and Sugar Land by the final of 6-5. The pitch, swung on, cue shot, grounder, foul to the backstop, 2-2. Sugar Land leading the all-time series with Southern Maryland 32-30. Last year they won the series 12-8. The pitch. Swing and a hot shot, base hit. Through the hole on the left side between Frawley and Ozuna. Anchored fielding it cleanly, stopping at second is Young. Back-to-back hits with one out. First and second here is Dustin Martin. Good chance here for the Skeeters. A team that has not led yet here in the series. They almost came back against this Blue Crabs bullpen on Tuesday night, but Barm and Berg, along with Hamrin, shutting it down. And then yesterday, a closer ball game, a 4-2 score. But not as much offense as the Skeeters would have liked. Pitch to Martin is outside. Dustin left-handed hitting left fielder. Walked and stole a base. His first time up. The kick, the pitch. Check swing, a called strike across the knees. One out, one ball and one strike is the count. No score, three hits apiece for both of these teams. Top of the fourth inning. Pitch, swung on, fouled straight back. Over the screen, out of play. And it's a ball and two strikes here to Dustin Martin. Martin, three RBIs in his last three games. 1-for-8 here in the series. Hale kicks and fires. Swung on. Serve foul back to the backstop. And we'll do it again. 1-2. Pretty good at bat here. Sixth pitch of the at bat coming to Dustin Martin. Guy who's a career 276 hitter in affiliated baseball with 80 home runs and over 500 RBIs. Over 1,000 games played. 1-2. Swing and a line drive. Straightaway center. Playable for DeJesus. Jogging back. Takes a one-hand catch, quickly getting into the left side. Runners stay put at first and second as Martin hit that one right on the nose. Two outs, first and second, scoreless here in the top of the fourth. And Denny Almonte will get a chance. Center fielder, number 17, Denny Almonte. Denny, the center fielder, struck out looking his first time up. Hale looking to work out of this mini jam here. Each team with three hits apiece. Monte switch hitter batting left. Open stance, the kick, and the first offer. Down and in, ball one. El Monte, not to be confused with Danny El Monte. Denny, D-E-N-N-Y, El Monte. Hitless yesterday. Drafted by the Mariners in the second round in 07 out of Florida Christian High School. 1-0. Down and in, two balls and no strikes. He advanced as high as AAA in the Mariners organization in 2013. Now, he was drafted with the 75th overall pick in the 07 draft, one ahead of Giancarlo Stanton of the Marlins. 2-0. Fastball. There's a strike over the outside corner. 2-1. Dale brings the hands together. He kicks and fires. In the dirt. Now three balls. Dale not happy with that last pitch. A fastball that was low. Balls behind El Monte. 3-1. Travis Scott waits to hit next. Delwin Young is at second base taking his lead. And the trail runner is Wallace at first taking his lead. Dale at the chest. Checks the runner twice at second. Now he kicks, twirls, and fakes the throw to second base. Nobody was there. Young walking back to the bag. Frawley at his normal position, back edge of the dirt. Stevenson at second base is about 3 feet behind the dirt on the outfield grass. Hale with the set position, the 3-1. Swung on, grounded to second. In two steps, Stevenson gloves and throws on to first base. And that does it. El Monte retired. And Sugarland stranding two. At the end of 3.5, Skeeters Blue Crabs scoreless here in game three of this three-game set on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network presented by Intrepid. Of the frame here in the fourth inning, scoreless ball game, Sugar Land and Southern Maryland on the intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Each team with three hits. Neither team has a run to show for it. Kyle Hankard leads off, takes the first offering outside. Sean Gallagher, fourth inning of work. Sean with five strikeouts in the game. Hankard, right-handed hitter, struck out his first time. Takes a fastball high. And it's 2-0. It'll be Hankard, Molina, and Ward. Gallagher with the gray pants rolled up to the knees, showing off the blue socks tonight. Black glove in front of the belt. Says yes. Now he turns, kicks the 2-0. Fastball taken for a called strike across the knees. Two balls and one strike is the count. Mentioned that Gallagher pitched parts of four seasons at the major league level. 2-1. Swung on, grounded to short. Step to his right, weaves. Scoops, and a long throw on to first is in time. Anchored out number one, and that'll bring Gustavo Molina to the plate. Gallagher pitching to the Cubs, the A's, the Padres, and the Pirates in four seasons. He made his major league debut at the age of 21 with the Cubs on June 9th of 2007 against Atlanta, went 3 1/3. Gave up three hits and two earned runs. Here's the pitch. Molina takes low, right-handed hitting catcher. Lined out softly to Weems at short, his first time up. Nobody on. One out. No score, bottom four. One out. Swung on, looped, behind second. Weems over from short to his left. He calls and makes a two-hand catch directly behind the second base bag on the back edge of the dirt. Molina 0 for 2. Base is empty. Two down. Here is Darryl Ward. Ward walked you slowly to the plate, trying to get back into rhythm with the bats. He's one of the hottest hitters, really, on this Blue Crabs team in the beginning of the season. Struggling as of late. Remember, though, he slid into a base over the weekend and felt some knee discomfort. Still not 100%. Grounded out to first. His first time up, takes the first offering for a called strike over the outside corner. No score here in the bottom of the fourth. Ward left-handed hitter with Fred Lewis waiting on deck. The one, the 0-1. Swung on, popped him up on the infield right side. In from first comes Scott onto the grass. Travis makes a two-hand catch, and Blue Crabs set down easily in order. 1-2-3. At the end of four innings of play, Skeeters nothing, Blue Crabs nothing. This is the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Top half of the fifth inning. We're moving right along here at Regency Furniture Stadium. It's a gorgeous night. Mid-60s here in Waldorf, Maryland. And the Skeeters and the Blue Crabs scoreless. This game number three of the three-game sets. Blue Crabs winning 7-5 on Tuesday. 4-2 yesterday in a special morning start time. Looking for the three-game sweep and their eighth straight win. Bottom three in the order coming to the plate for Sugarland. Travis Scott, Patrick Palmero, and Todd Jennings against right-hander Jake Hale. Hale has thrown 36 strikes here in the ball game. And overall, he has three strikeouts. He's allowed three hits. The righty winds and fires. Swing and a line drive roped into right. That falls down in front of Lewis for a base hit. Fields it cleanly. And Scott, who struck out swinging his first time, is a leadoff base runner. Four hits now in the game for the Skeeters. And here is Patrick Palmero, who is 1-for-1 with a single. Patrick singled back in third inning. Hale, a guy who came out of Ohio State University, had a fine, fine college career, was one strikeout shy of 200 for his amateur career. Checks over his left shoulder, brings the hands together. First offering. Swung on, fouled straight back to the net. Jake was a starter his freshman year at age 20 at Ohio State. Went 4-5 with 3.38 ERA. After the season, he was called into his coach's office. Said, hey, what's up, coach? What do you need? So he says, Jake, I'm going to have you as the closer next year. Jake said, sure, okay. Well, the next year he went 4-3, ERA 4.25, 0-1. Swung on and missed, 0-2. He saved 10 games. Very nice job. He also had 48 strikeouts that year. Now, the next year, after the 07 season, coach calls him into his office again and says, hey, Jake, how are you? Coach, I'm doing well. Arm feels great. What can I do for you? Well, he says, Jake, I'm going to move you back to being a starter again. Well, the next year, in 08, as a starter, 02, hey, you got him looking. Strike three on the outside corner. Hale with strikeout number four. One out for Ty Jennings. So, in 08 as a junior at Ohio State, Hale went 5-3, a 4.50 ERA and 11 starts. Okay, after the 08 season, I think you're starting to get the pattern here. Coach, what do you need? We're going to have you as closer again, Jake. Sure. So in 2009, Jake, as a senior at age 23, first pitch to Jennings, a slider strike. He was the closer again. Went 0-1 and has had his best year by far in college. 1.31 ERA. 40 games, he didn't start any of them. And he had 18 saves that year, which was good for third most in the Big Ten Conference. 0-1. Outside with a fastball, and of course, the rest is history with Hale getting drafted for the third time. Second time out of Ohio State University by the Arizona Diamondbacks as a senior in 2009 at age 23. A ball and a strike, no score, top five. The 1-1. Down the way, a breaking ball. And it's 2-1 here to the right-handed hitting catcher, Todd Jennings, who grounded into a 6-4-3 double play his first time. Travis Scott led off the inning with a single. He's at first. Hale brings the hands together. Outfielders play straight up. The 2-1. Swung on, looped in the air. Behind the mound, Hale is backpedaling. Caught off by Frawley coming in from short. And Casey, about 3 feet behind the mound, makes the two-hand catch. Hale was backpedaling on that hill off the mound. And Casey said, I'm getting this one. It's all right, Jake. You stick to pitching, we'll field, and that's exactly what Casey did there. Two outs, a runner at first base. Back to the top of the order. Here is Kevin Russo. Kevin is 0-2 with a pop out and a ground out. Right-handed hitter. Hale set. The kick and the pitch. Swung on, popped him up foul off first. Crossing into foul ground. Behind the coach's box is Wilson. Drifts onto the track. And Zach makes a one-hand catch for out number three. No runs, a hit. And one man left at first base. Moving right along here at Regency Furniture Stadium. We head to the bottom half of the fifth inning. Skeeters and the Blue Crabs are scoreless. You're listening to the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. All right, fans, let's take a look
out.
Hey, fans, after the game, don't forget to stop in to your local food store and pick up one of the many delicious Turkey Hill products. Turkey Hill timeless goodness coming through. Red Lewis will lead things off. Lewis, the left-handed hitting right fielder, 7-8-9, Lewis Stevenson Frawley. Scoreless bottom half of the fifth inning here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Another inning of work for the right-hander, Sean Gallagher. Either team with bullpen activity. Gallagher deals a fastball outside. It's 1-0 to Fred Lewis. He struck out looking his first time up. Here's the windup, the 1-0. Taken for called strike over the inside corner. Gallagher, four innings pitch thus far. Pitch, down and in. Sean has allowed three hits, striking out five. He has not walked anybody. 15 batters faced overall. Lewis, slightly open stance, left side. The wind, the pitch. Swing and a foul, sent straight back to the screen. 2-2 is the count to Fred. Blue Crabs, the team hitting 308 here this series. 267 here at home. 2-2 the count, nobody out. The turn, the kick, and the pitch. Skips up in the dirt. An off-speed pitch that was spiked. Gallagher not very happy with himself. It's a full count, three balls and two strikes. Gallagher, the 30-year-old from Boston, Massachusetts, looking for his sixth strikeout here in the game. Rocks on the rubber, the payoff. Now low ball four. First free pass issued tonight by Sean Gallagher. Here's Casey Stevenson. Stevenson struck out swinging his first time up. Gallagher brings the hands together. Now the first offering. Stevenson squares, drops the bunt down foul up the third base line. Gallagher in 2005 was named the Cubs Minor League Pitcher of the Year. And his breaking ball, which we've talked about tonight, that 12-6 curveball, was voted as the best in the Midwest League, while with the Peoria Chiefs. Nothing and one the count. Lead by Lewis at first. Quick throw to the bag, and Lewis hopping back in. Feet first safely. Red 0-1 in stolen base attempts this season. Guy who has been bothered at times this season by a hamstring injury. Stevenson, the guy at the plate, as far as we know, has been healthy. Left-handed hitter. Squares 0-1. Drops down the bunt up the first base line as it bounces onto the grass and spins foul. Picked up by Jennings in foul ground, and Stevenson in the hole here, nothing in two, as he walks back to the home plate area. And you would think here that the bunt would be off. Stevenson 2-for-7 this series, 7 for his last 15 though. He comes in having hit safely in 6 of his last 7 games. 0-2 the count. Nobody out. Scoreless bottom half of the fifth inning. Blue Crabs three hits in the game. Gallagher from the stretch. Stevenson squares 0-2. Drops down the bunt in front of the plate. Fair. Picked up by Jennings with the bare hand. Sidearms down to first. Lewis to second base. And Stevenson does the job. With two strikes, Casey is able to get that sack bunt down. And now the number 9 hitter, Casey Frawley, will get a chance. Lewis in scoring position. Frawley grounding out his first time up. Blue Crabs, the team hitting 232 with runners in scoring position. Not the best mark, but certainly a mark that was a lot different from where it was in the beginning of the year. First part of the year, they were hitting under 200 with runners in scoring position. Frawley, right-handed hitter. The set position, the 0-1. Raleigh swings and hits a fly ball, shallow right center field. Almonte sprinting in from center. He calls and makes a one-hand catch in stride. And Lewis takes one step back to second base. Two outs, runner in scoring position. And now it's Anton DeJesus. And Anton has really struggled with runners in scoring position, hitting at just a 182 clip. DeJesus with a single back in the third and a stolen base. He's one for two. Outfielders play straight away. Bottom half of the fifth inning and a scoreless ball game here tonight at Regency Furniture Stadium. Pretty good crowd on hand. Blue Crabs will remain home tomorrow, four-game set against Somerset. Two outs. Gallagher kicks and fires. Down and in. Ball one. Left-handed hitting Anton DeJesus. Gallagher leaning at the waist. Brings the hands together. Now the 1-0. Fastball in there. Called strike over the outer third. One ball and one strike is the count. Skeeters this year 2-2 with Gallagher on the mound. Sean has pitched really well here tonight, as has his counterpart, Jake Hale. Two outs, the 1-1. Swung on, popped him up, foul, third base side. Crossing into foul ground, Palmeiro, behind the coach's box, makes a one-hand catch. Lewis walking and taking second base on the sack bunt by Casey Stevenson, but Frawley and DeJesus unable to knock in Fred. And at the end of five innings of play, Skeeters Blue Crabs scoreless here at Regency Furniture Stadium on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Top half of the sixth inning, Skeeters and Blue Crabs. Scoreless on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Intrepid empowering business to communicate with clarity. Skeeters four hits, Blue Crabs with just three. Beamer Weems to lead things off against the right-hander Jake Hale. And Jake is like his counterpart. Sean Gallagher has pitched really well tonight. Five innings, no runs, four hits, one walk, and four strikeouts. It'll be Weems, Young, and Wallace. Weems 0 for 1, the pitch taken a little bit high. Beamer was hit by a pitch back in the first. Told you the story last night of when he was playing for the San Antonio Missions when he was hit by a pitch right in the face. A 95 mile per hour fastball underneath the eye. 1-0. Taken outside and it's two balls and no strikes. Broke bones in his eye socket, his navel cavity, and his cheekbone as well. And Beamer's a tough young man. 2-0. Swung on, popped him up on the infield right side. Stevenson, Wilson, Zach, the first baseman, calls and makes a two-hand catch, even with the bag on the dirt. And Weems is out number one. To finish what I was saying, though, about Beamer, He once played 30 games in a season with a torn ligament in his thumb when he was in college at Baylor University. Tough young man. Good hitter, scrappy ball player. Bops out for round number one. Here's Delwin Young. Playing with a torn ligament in your thumb is harder than it sounds, trust me. Here's the pitch from Hale. Jake deals a fastball strike over the inside corner. Young didn't like it, lifting up the elbows and looking back at home plate umpire Drew Hoglin. Delwin's one for two with a single in the fourth. Switch hitter batting left. Hale kicks the 0-1. Taking low, a changeup. One ball and one strike is the count. The wind, the 1-1. Swung on, popped him up foul. Third base side, Molina throwing off the mask. Near the on-deck circle. Runs out of room up against the sidewall as it lands two rows into the seats. Molina really sprinting over onto the warning track. He found it fairly easily, but it just went out of play. Ball and two strikes here to Delwin Young with Chris Wallace waiting on deck. Top of the sixth, no score. Hale turns, kicks, and fires. Swung on, popped him up again on the infield. Foul ground, Hale coming off the mound, crossing in the foul ground. Makes a two-hand catch. Molina just couldn't find it. It really was Stavo's baseball, but again, he was looking up into the air. He put both palms up to the air and said, "Hey guys, I can't find it." So Hale came off the mound and made the catch. Did it himself, nicely done by Jake. Two pop-ups, two outs. Nobody on. Here's Chris Wallace. Chris one for two in the ball game, a single in the fourth. Hale looking for the 1-2-3 inning. He's retired five straight. He's giving up that single in the top of the fifth to Travis Scott. Here's the pitch. Swung on, popped foul off first. Crossing into foul ground, Wilson onto the track, and he watches it peel out of play about four rows into the seats. And it's 0-1 to the right-handed hitting DH. Came into the game hitting at over 300, 304 to be exact. Hale rocks, kicks the 0-1. Jake pours in a fastball for a strike on the outside corner. 0-2 here to Chris. Wallace, a guy who attended the University of Houston. 0-2. Waved at and missed. A slider. And that's the fifth strikeout for Jake Hale, who is now retired six straight. At the end of 5.5. Skeeters Blue Crabs scoreless. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid.
Thank you.
Home half of the sixth inning here at Regency Furniture Stadium. No score, the Skeeters and the Blue Crabs on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Intrepid empowering business to communicate with clarity. Renny Ozuna to lead things off. It'll be Ozuna, Wilson, Hankert. Blue Crabs three hits in the game. Sean Gallagher, the right-hander, ready to work. He's got five Ks, the pitch. Waved at and missed by the right-hander hitting Ozuna. It's 0-1. Sean has walked a guy. Five-plus innings of work. 19 batters faced overall. The kick, the 0-1. Taken low, one ball and one strike. Gallagher, 30 years of age, from Boston, Massachusetts. The 1-1. In tight at the knees, backing Ozuna off the plate. Now two balls and one strike. We mentioned that Gallagher spent parts of four seasons at the major league level. Next offering, a little bit high, 3-1. And a cool story, on July 19th of 2008, he was pitching for the Oakland Athletics. And Gallagher, here's a 3-1, swung on, hit in the air, left center field, playable for Martin, who makes a one-hand catch near the gap. And in that inning for Gallagher, he struck out the side of, ready for this, Derek Jeter, Bobby Abreu, and Alex Rodriguez. That's a story you can tell your kids someday. I struck out one of the best shortstops of all time in Derek Jeter, a fine, fine player in Bobby Abreu, and a great player in Alex Rodriguez. Wilson takes down low in the first offering. Zach tonight is 1-for-2 with a single back in the first. Here's the windup and the 1-0. Swing and a ball served in the air, foul, first base side, out of play. Gallagher in that ball game, where he struck out the side of Jeter, Abreu, and Rodriguez, struck out 7 overall, allowed 2 runs over 5 innings of work. 1-1. In the dirt, 2 balls and 1 strike. Struck out Rodriguez twice, Jorge Posada, another fine, fine player, twice. And then he struck out Jeter, Abreu, and Brett Gardner. The turn, the kick, the 2-1. Cut on, foul tip in and out of the mitt of Jennings. It's 2-2. Gallagher, 10-10 at the major league level. 5.64 ERA in 91 games. 2-2. Cut on, and a grounder fouled the backstop. I mean, 23 starts out of those 91 games pitched at the major league level with the Cubs, the A's, the Padres, and the Pirates. 2-2, nobody on. No score, bottom six, one out. Wilson, the number three hitter, looking to work his way on. Gallagher, first base edge of the rubber, rocks and fires. Cut on, a foul off to the right, out of play. Kyle Hankert waits to hit next. The wind, the 2-2. Swing and a soft liner into center. Falling quickly, Almonte coming on. It touches down onto the grass, a base hit. Wilson's 2-for-3, and he keeps swinging. Hankert 4-for-7 in this series coming into the night. He's 4-for-9 with his 0-for-2 at the plate here this evening. He struck out swinging in the first, and he grounded out to short in the fourth. The pitch. Down the way, nice backhand pick by Jennings. Slightly out of his crouch. 1-0 the count to the right-handed hitting Hankert. Hankert coming in on an 8-game hitting streak. He's hitting .448 during that streak. 2 home runs, 7 RBIs. Remember, he missed almost a week with a mild concussion. The 1-0 offering. Swung on line, just foul. Down the left field side, bouncing up against the sidewall into the Blue Crabs bullpen. Neither team with bullpen activity just yet. Down the left field and right field line. A ball and a strike with one out. No score here in the bottom of the sixth. Game three of this 3-game set. Blue Crabs looking to win their 8th straight. Southern Maryland 12-7 on the season coming in. First in the Freedom Division. The 1-1 offering. Swung on, fouled away, right side into the seats. Anchored an Atlantic League All-Star in 2013. He had 322 that season, which was tied for third in the league, 22 home runs and 61 runs driven in. If he continues with this pace, guess what? He's going to be an All-Star again. Here's the set. Now the 1-2. Swung on and missed. Gallagher recording the strikeout. And that's his sixth of the ball game. He's gotten hankered twice down waving here tonight, and both on relatively the same pitch, that breaking ball down the way. Hankered looking fooled back in the first on that breaking ball to strike out, and now here in the sixth, striking out swinging. Here's Gustavo Molina. Two outs, a runner at first base in Wilson. No score, bottom six. Gallagher kicks and fires. A fastball, a little bit low. Molina tonight is 0 for 2 with a pair of pop-outs to short. Right-handed hitter. Here's the set position by Gallagher. From the belt. The pitch. Swing and a line drive out of the range of the shortstop. Leans into left center field. Wilson on his way to third. The throw, the bag is offline and too late. Martin, the left fielder, with his throw. A line drive throw, pulling Palmeiro off the bag. Great base running by Zach Wilson. Off the crack of the bat, running from first. Meanwhile, on that base hit by Molina, it was out of the range of Weems, the shortstop. And in the left center field it went. Weems ranging to his left. I thought he was going to try to dive for it and make a play, but he stayed upright and went right past his glove. And his outstretched left arm as well. Here's Darryl Ward. Two hits in the inning for the Blue Crabs. They've got five in the game. Here's the pitch. Darryl takes a called strike over the inside corner. Left-handed hitting DH. 0 for 2 in the game. Darryl, after the ball game yesterday morning, was working out in the cage, doing some one-handed drills off a tee with Jamar Walton. Trying to break out of this mini slump that he is in. Here's the set position, the 0-1. Swung on, hit in the air, right field, over towards the line, circling into his left, Russo. He's underneath and makes a one-hand catch in stride for out number three, and hung up there, I should say, a little bit too long. Blue Crabs with two singles, but unable to score, leaving two runners on base, and they have left six on here tonight. Six innings in the books, Skeeters, Blue Crabs, scoreless. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, presented by Intrepid. Jake Hill continuing to throw his warm-up tosses. As we head to the top of the seventh, scoreless Charlotte Hall Veterans Home, celebrating its 30th anniversary, is focused on caring for Maryland's veterans and their spouses in an environment focusing on individualized services to enhance their quality of life. Charlotte Hall Veterans Home provides an assisted living and skilled nursing long-term care facility for Maryland veterans and eligible spouses who are unable to take care of themselves due to their age or disability. Located at 29449 Charlotte Hall Road in Charlotte Hall, Maryland, Charlotte Hall Veterans Home provides top service standards. More information, call 301-884-8171. That's 301-884-8171 or visit charhall.org. That is www.charhall.org. Hale, seventh inning of work. He deals a fastball outside to the left-handed hitting Dustin Martin, the left fielder, who is 0-for-1 here tonight with a walk and a stolen base. Four hits for the Skeeters, five for the Blue Crabs. Top seven, scoreless game, 1-0. Swung on, looped out to left field. Hankard sprinting. He reaches out, and he makes a one-hand snag at the shoe tops. Nice play by Kyle Hankard. That one kept falling and falling quickly. Martin robbed of a hit. One out here is Denny Elmonte. Time now for our Blackstone Management out-of-town scoreboard. As always, we will start in the Atlantic League tonight. The Bluefish and the Ducks doing battle at Bethpage Ballpark in Long Island. 8-6, the Bluefish have the lead. Here's the pitch. Elmonte takes a called strike. Elsewhere, the Barnstormers and the Patriots tied at one. Next offering is popped up on the infield right side. Near the mound, Wilson. Now Ozuna calling off Wilson from third, and Rennie makes the catch right on the mound. That one started on the right side of the infield, drifted back towards the mound, and Rennie made a nice play. Elmonte is 0-for-3. Here's Travis Scott. Revolution and the River Sharks appears like they are canceled here tonight. Scott, left-handed hitter. Patriots, the next opponent for the Blue Crabs. First pitch. Called strike, a breaking ball on the inside. Patriots coming into the night 11-6. They'll be here this weekend for four games. One right now with Lancaster. 0-1. Cue shot, grounder, foul outside of third. We'll check some scores from around Major League Baseball tonight. The Yankees and the Rays in the bottom of the fifth inning. And it's 5-0 Rays. Yankees 21-14 on the night. Giants and the Reds both 17-17. Giants lead the Reds 2-1. Hale into the line. Here comes an 0-1. Outside. Ball and a strike, nobody on, two down, top seven, no score. Bottom half of the second inning in Houston, the Astros 21-13. Blue Jays a game under 500, they lead it 2-1 tonight. The pitch, down and in. Now the count evens up, two balls and two strikes. Elsewhere around baseball, not many games to speak of, only 11 tonight on this Thursday, May 14th. Boston and Seattle tonight. Here's a 2-2 pitch. Outside, fastball. 10-10 first pitch, East Coast time. Seattle 15-18 on the year. Boston 16-18. Joe Kelly to throw for the Red Sox against Ronis Elias. 0-1 with a 3.86 ERA on the year. Hawaii, the 3-2 pitch. Cole, third strike. He got him looking at the knees. Jake Hale with six strikeouts in the game. And he has retired nine straight. At the end of 6.5, it's the Skeeters nothing, and the Blue Crabs nothing on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network presented by Intrepid.
your local Philadelphia party event and the score right here at Game Park in the area. Find yourself in the way. Welcome back to the work just at the top. Trust Metal Solutions is the answer.
Fans up and stretching here in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Scoreless ball game. Skeeters and the Blue Crabs. Game three of this three-game set. Blue Crabs looking for the sweep and their eighth straight win. Skeeters coming in, having lost six of their last seven. Five hits for Southern Maryland. Four for the Skeeters here tonight. Sean Gallagher towing the rubber once again. And he will start his seventh inning of work. Sean tonight has allowed five hits. One walk, six strikeouts. Fred Lewis leads off, takes a breaking ball for a strike. Bottom three in the order, Lewis, Stevenson, Frawley. Fred 0 for 1 with a walk back in the fifth. The only walk issue tonight by Gallagher, the 0-1. In the dirt, one ball and one strike. Continuing with our Blackstone Management out-of-town scoreboard. The Cardinals beat the Indians today by the final of 2-1. 1-1 pitch in the dirt as St. Louis winning their 24th game. One of the best teams right now in all of baseball. Kevin Segrist picked up the win. He's 2-0. Rebzinski against his former team took the loss. Rosenthal his 12th save. Lewis takes a fastball in the dirt, now 3-1. Matt Carpenter hitting his sixth home run today for St. Louis. Meanwhile, the Phillies beat the Pirates today by the final of 4-2. 3-1. Down and in, ball four. Lewis walks for the second time here tonight. Leadoff base runner on. Here's Casey Stevenson. Bullpen activity down the right field line for the Skeeters. The pitch. Stevenson swings and hits it in the air. Foul up the left field side, out of play. Aaron Harang picked up the win. Worley took the loss against his former team. Papelbon is eighth save. Tigers beat up today on the Twins. Win their 21st game. 13-1. Anibal Sanchez the win, his third of the year. Mike Pelfrey took the loss, his first of the year. Quick throw to first base. Lewis diving back in, head first safely. Castellanos with his third home run. Miguel Cabrera with two home runs today. That's eight on the season for Miguel. Royals beat the Rangers 6-3 earlier today. The 0-1 in the dirt. Nice block by Jennings using the chest protector. Royals 22-13 on the year. Jeremy Guthrie with his third win. Ross Detweiler with the loss. 0-5. 6.95 ERA. Greg Holland is seventh save. Eric Hosmer homering today for the Royals. Lewis is leadoff first. It'll be a 1-1. Lewis breaks for second. Here's a swing and a line drive left center field. Into the gap goes Almonte to his right. Denny makes a one-hand catch. Now he throws it back to first base behind Lewis on a bounce. And it's a little bit late as Fred sliding back in head first safely. That was very close. Stevenson hit it right on the nose. Almonte catching that one at the chest and showing off that arm strength, nearly throwing out Fred Lewis, who was running on the play. Here's Casey Frawley. No score here. Bottom of the seventh inning, one out. Our final game on the Blackstone Management out-of-town scoreboard on the Major League side of things. The Cubs today beating the Mets 6-5. I was watching some of Matt Harvey pitch last night. Boy, can he pitch, and he's still young. He's going to have a great career. That's going to be fun watching him do. The pitch to Frawley. Casey waves and misses. Shortstop 0 for 2 here tonight. Bats from the right side. Pedro Strop took the win today for Chicago. Jonathan East, the loss. Drops the 3-3. Rendon, the save, is 8th. Dexter Fowler, a home run today for the Cubs, his third. The 0-1. Frawley squares, drops the bunt down right side. Gallagher off the mound, bare hands, sets, fires on to first, a chest-high throw to Scott, staying home on the play. Frawley is out. To second goes Lewis. Back to the top of the order. Here is Antone DeJesus, runner in scoring position with two outs. That does it for our Blackstone Management Out of Town scoreboard. Scoreless here, bottom of the seventh at Regency Furniture Stadium. Here comes Gary Gaetti out to have a meeting with his right-hander, Sean Gallagher. The Blue Crabs with five hits here tonight. They've left six runners on. Meeting at the mound is over. Gallagher tonight, six strikeouts, two walks, and six and two-thirds, allowing five hits overall. Jake Hale on the other side has done a great job. Seven innings, four hits, one walk, six Ks. DeJesus, left-handed hitter, he's one for three with a single and a stolen base. The leadoff man for this Blue Crabs team. Outfielders play straight away. Wind picks up a little bit here at the ballpark. Gallagher from the stretch. Here's the pitch. Down and in for ball one. Lewis taking a relatively big secondary lead out there. Base hit to the outfield, should be able to score him. Remember, Russo, a good arm in right. Almonte, a good arm in center. Martin, a decent arm in left. But Lewis will have to be on his horse for the base hit to left field if he wants to score, because it's short out there. 1-0. Down and in. I say it's a lot, but it's worth mentioning again. Remember, 3-10 down the left field line. So it's relatively short in left field. And it's a short throw, really, to any base. 2-0. Here's the kick and the pitch. Swung on. A looper out to shallow center. Back from second goes Young. He calls. And Delwin makes a two-hand catch for out number three. Blue Crab strands seven. DeJesus unable to get the run in. Southern Maryland and the Skeeters are still scoreless. We head to the eighth. This is the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Top half of the eighth inning, and we are scoreless. Great ball game, great pitching matchup here tonight. Jake Hale against Sean Gallagher. Both guys are doing a great job here tonight. Hale with six strikeouts. Patrick Palomero will lead things off, 8-9-1. Righty Hale turns, kicks, and fires. Swung on, hit high in the air. Left field, medium depth. Tankard jogging into the spots. Kyle makes a one-hand catch off his left shoulder. Palomero retired on one pitch. He's one for three tonight. Here's Todd Jennings. Blue Crabs tonight looking for the sweep of the Skeeters and their eighth straight win overall as well. Here's the pitch. Jennings takes a little bit high. Todd tonight 0 for 2. He's grounded into a 6-4-3 double play. And he popped out to the shortstop, Frawley. The 0-1 on the way. Swing and a miss. Nice breaking ball. Jennings hitting 293 with Sugar Land last year. 1-1. Cut on, foul tip at the plate. The wind, the 1-2. Swing and a ball served softly on a line foul outside of first. Jennings got that right off the end of the bat. Hale has gone 7 innings twice this season. Working into the 8th inning here tonight. Certainly deserves the win, but his offense just hasn't really been there. That's the same on the other side with Sean Gallagher. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. And Jake Hale with 7 strikeouts in the game. 2 up, 2 down, nobody on. Hale has retired 11 straight. Here is Kevin Russo. Top 8 were scoreless. Right-handed hitting Russo, the right fielder, 0 for 3 here tonight. The wind and the pitch. Fastball grounded over the mound back towards the middle. To his right, Stevenson fields behind second. Throw to first is in time. Jake Hale has retired 12 straight. Russo breaking his bat. He's 0 for 4. And the Skeeters set down in order. Home half of the 8th inning. Skeeters, Blue Crabs. Scoreless on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Powered by Intrepid. Ozuna to lead things off, bottom of the 8th. New pitcher Robbie Weinhart. 0-1 on the season, a 6.75 ERA. Gallagher finish. Sean 7 innings tonight, not allowing a run. 5 hits, 2 walks, 6 Ks. The pitch. The right-hander deals a fastball up high to the right-hander hitting Ozuna. Rennie will be followed by Wilson and Hanker. Ozuna tonight is 1 for 3. Olmero hugs the line at third behind the bag. The kick, the 1-0. Swung on, ground to short. Weems up with it. Quickly throws on to first, and Ozuna is out on 2 pitches. 6 appearance for Weinhardt. Four innings. Opponents hitting .474 against him. There's five strikeouts on the season and two walks. Doesn't appear that the Blue Crabs have any activity in their bullpen down the left field line. Zach Wilson, the batter. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Nice off-speed pitch. Good tight spin to him. Right-handed hitting Wilson a little bit out in front. Zach tonight, another good night at the plate. 2-for-3. Playing first base here tonight. Straightaway stance. The 0-1. Down the way. One ball and one strike. Reinhardt does have a save on the season. Last appearance against Camden went an inning. He held the 6-2 lead in the sixth inning of that ball game. That was back on the 11th of May. One out, nobody on. The 1-1 offering. Swung on, popped foul out of play to the right. Big stories of this ball game have been the two starting pitchers. Jake Hale tonight has pitched beautifully for Southern Maryland. 8 innings of work, 4 hits, 1 walk, 7 Ks. And up to this point, he has retired 12 straight. The 1-2 to Wilson. Down the way in the dirt. Gallagher on the other side. Sean, 7 innings tonight, 5 hits, 2 walks, 6 strikeouts in 28 batters faced. Now he is finished. And we will see if Jake Hale goes out for the ninth. It could be the case that we see Hale in the ninth, and then Stan Clyburn is going to be hoping that his team can win it in the bottom of the ninth, or maybe pick up a run here. 2-2. Swing and a miss. Down goes Wilson, a slider. Pretty nasty pitch from Robbie Weinhardt. Two up, two down. Scoreless here in the bottom of the eighth. Here's Kyle Hecker, who's 0-for-3. Weinhardt, a former Tigers 10th round draft pick in 08 from Oklahoma State. Hankered right-handed hitter. Remember, with Hankered up, one swing of the bat, and we could see this game change entirely. And I say that because we're scoreless. Here's the pitch. In tight. Oh, that got a piece of Hankered. You can hear it up here, and you hope that didn't get his hand. But it sounded like he might have got some bone. Didn't sound good. Maybe not his hand, maybe his forearm, but it appears as though he's okay here as he jogs down the first base line. He's a two-out base runner. You can kind of hear that from up here, the bone, something of that nature. Getting a piece of the baseball or vice versa. Hanker, though, appears to be okay. Remember, he just came back from a mild concussion. He's at first base. Here's Gustavo Molina, who's 1-for-3. Two outs, pitch. Gustavo takes high. Molina, the right-handed hitting catcher. Mild three-game hitting streak. 5-for-7 with 2 home runs and 3 RBIs in this series. Two outs, the 1-0. Outside, a slider that hung up. And it's 2-0. Weinhardt pitched 2 seasons at the major league level with the Tigers. Went 2-2, a 6.39 ERA. 2-0. Swung on, bounced over the mound towards second. Past the diving Young in the center field. A base hit for Gustavo Molina. Stopping at second is Hankered. And Molina 2-for-4 here on the night. Blue Crabs 6 hits. Looking for their first run of the ball game. And it's Hankered standing 180 feet away at second base. Here's Darryl Ward, left-handed hitter coming up. Gary Gaetti appears to be going to the bullpen, and I think he's going to call out the left-hander here to face the left-handed hitting Ward, who tonight, Darryl, is 0-for-3. This will do it for Weinhardt, who retired the first two hitters fairly easily, hit Hankered with a pitch, and Molina singling back up the middle. We've got a pitching change here tonight, here in the eighth. And it will be a left-hander. We'll tell you more about him when we get back. Bottom of the eighth, Blue Crabs threatening, no score. Kyle Hankered is at second, Molina is at first. Two outs, Darryl Ward will be the batter. when we get back on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. What's up?
1572 10 minutes.
Cool, thanks man. Pitcher. He comes out of the bullpen for Weinhardt, who went 2/3 of an inning. And Derek Loop, the left-hander, as Barry Gaetti plays the matchups here. Darryl Ward will be the hitter. He's 0-3 here tonight. $3,118 is the attendance here tonight at Regency Furniture Stadium. And they're hoping for a run here in the bottom of the eighth. The pitch. Ward takes a slider for a called strike on the outside corner, and Darryl doesn't like it. It's a couple of words for Drew Hoglund, the home plate umpire. Lets him know about it. Drew standing his ground. Darryl still talking here to Drew as he steps out. Still with some words. Not happy about that last pitch. Luke, the left-hander. 12 strikeouts, 2 walks this year. This is 9th appearance, 8 innings pitched. Time called. Luke stepping off the rubber. Luke 6-3, 220. On relief for Weinhardt. The two runners on base, Hankard and Molina, his responsibility. He had hit Hankard. Molina singling back up the middle. 2 outs. 0-1 the count. No score. Loop kicks and fakes the throw to second base, much to the dismay of the fans here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Here's the set. The 0-1. Outside. Really the same spot. Ward took the pitch. 1-1. Luke grabs 6 hits in the game. Loop is the third pitcher for Gary Gaetti here tonight. The 1-1. Swung on, hit in the air, straightaway center, but playable for El Monte. Going back, squares up and makes the catch for out number 3. So that does it for the Blue Crabs, and they have left 9 runners on base here tonight. No runs, a hit, no error. And 2 men left. We head to the top half of the 9th inning. Skeeters and the Blue Crabs scoreless. This is the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Okay, sending hail back out there again. I like it. I like it. There was bullpen activity down the left field line, but Stan Clyburn has decided he's going to stick with Hale, who will start his ninth inning of work here tonight. Scoreless ball game, Southern Maryland and Sugar Land. Beamer Weems to lead things off. 2-3-4, Weems, Young, Wallace. Blue Crabs with two runners on in the bottom of the eighth, unable to score. They've left nine on here tonight. Hale rocks on the rubber and fires. Fastball, a little bit high. Hale tonight. Eight innings plus, four hits allowed, one walk, seven strikeouts. Certainly deserves the win. Came in 2-1 on the year, 1-0. Swung on, popped him up. Shallow center, DeJesus Stevenson. It's DeJesus calling. And the center fielder makes the two-hand grab. Hale making it look easy here tonight. Here is Delwin Young. Think about this starting rotation for the Blue Crabs, and we've talked about it virtually the entire year. Brian Burris at the top, injured right now. Here's the first offering. A little bit high, but he has certainly pitched when he's been out there like a number one. And then Sean Garceau, who is a workhorse. I mean, here's a guy who's gone eight innings a couple of times this year, 1-0. Swung on, lined out to second, right over the head of the leaping Stevenson into right center field. Lewis plays it cleanly, throws it in towards second, and it's a single for Delwin Young. He's 2-for-4 here tonight. Five hits in the game for the Skeeters. But then, of course, you think about the one question mark, and that's the spot. And, of course, the question is, when is Burris going to get back? But the big question in this Blue Crabs rotation is that spot that Gabby Hernandez has left a void in, that number three spot. Remember Gabby leaving for Taiwan. Wade Corby got the start the other night, went five innings, picked up the win. Here's Wallace, the pitch. Now low to Chris. Wallace tonight is 1-for-3, now on a 10-game hitting streak. But then, of course, Brian Baker pitching well last night, picking up the win. And now Jake Hale here tonight, pitching 8 1/3 and allowing just five hits. The 1-0. Swung on, popped foul out of play to the right. I mean, you think about this rotation, it's got to be right now one of the best in the league. Just with the way these guys have pitched. And on a nightly basis, giving you quality starts. And if you're Stan Clyburn, you got to be happy with that. The 1-1. Breaking ball, a called strike over the outer third. It's 1-2, and Hale is looking for his eighth strikeout. By the way, before that single by Delwin Young, I forgot to mention this. But before that single, Hale retired 13 straight. Jake brings the hands together. One out, the 1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Down goes Wallace, the DH. And Hale with eight strikeouts here tonight. That Young single was the first hit since Travis Scott's single back in the fifth. Two outs, and here's the left-handed hitting Dustin Martin. Dustin tonight 0-for-2, a pair of flyouts and a walk. Throw a stolen base in there as well. The only walk issued, by the way, by Hale tonight. The pitch. Jake pours in a fastball strike across the knees. Two outs, Young the runner at first, Delwin this season 1-for-1 in stolen base attempts. Five hits for the Skeeters, six for the Blue Crabs. Ozuna 2 feet behind the bag at third, outfielders deep all the way around, pitch. Swung on, hit in the air, right center field, medium depth. Lewis sprinting over to his right into the gap, gives way to DeJesus. And Antone the center fielder makes a two-hand catch in the gap for out number three. No runs, a hit, one man left, and Jake Hale with a phenomenal performance here tonight. We'll see if the Blue Crabs can win it in the bottom of the ninth inning. Blue Crabs will send the bottom three in the order, Lewis, Stevenson, and Frawley to the plate. Bottom of the ninth, Skeeters, Blue Crabs, scoreless. You're listening to the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Of the ninth inning scoreless game, Skeeters Blue Crabs in game three of this three-game set. Blue Crabs booked to win their eighth straight. They've got a chance to do it here in the bottom of the ninth. A possible walk-off situation. Lewis, Stevenson, Frawley. Fred is 0-for-1 with two walks in the ballgame. Lefty on lefty. Derek Loop, the 6'3 left-hander from Norco, California. Works from the stretch and deals. Called strike over the outer third. Blue Crabs, their best chances to score came in the first. They put two runners on. And then again in the sixth, they put two runners on again, but were unable to get anything across. The 0-1 up high. They've left nine runners on base here tonight. John Gallagher started the game, went seven innings, allowing five hits, two walks, six Ks. 1-1. Swung on, bounced slowly right side. Coming over from first is Scott. He flips it underhand to Loop, and it's not in time. A slowly hit grounder, and Lewis legged it out. Blue Crabs with seven hits in the game. Here's Casey Stevenson. Stevenson is 0-for-2 here tonight with a sack bunt. Squares here as Luke throws over to first. Lewis back in safely standing. Weinhardt came out of the bullpen tonight for Sugar Land, went 2/3 of an inning. And now it's Luke. The big story of this ballgame on the other side. Jake Hill, Hale, a phenomenal, phenomenal game. 9 innings pitched here tonight. 5 hits, 1 walk, 8 Ks. Another throw to first, Lewis diving back in, and it's a balk! Luke balking! And now Derek wants to have a word here with the first base umpire, Bill Worthington, so does Gary Gaetti. Luke kicked and threw over to first base, and I think he went by that imaginary line, and a balk was called. And when you go past that imaginary line, again, it's umpire's discretion. It's so close. It's like splitting hairs. But when you go past that imaginary line, as Loop did right there, it's a balk. And Lewis is in scoring position. We'll see if Frawley here, or rather Stevenson here, is bunting. Frawley is on deck. And if Stevenson bunts and gets Lewis over to third, all they need is a fly ball. or a possible win. Romero inching in at third. Stevenson squares, drops down the bunt foul up the third base line. It's 0-1. I would imagine here that he will be bunting again. Now the rotation play, it appears, is on here for Sugarland. Scott charging from first. Palmero is charging from third. And the second baseman, Young, is covering the first base bag. Some late drama here at Regency Furniture Stadium tonight. No score. Bottom nine. Stevenson squares 0-1. Stabs at it and drops it down foul right at the plates. And it's 0-2, and let's see if Casey's got it again here. Drop down a sack bunt in the fifth. Struck out swinging in the second. Flew out to center in the seventh. Here's the set by Loop. Checks the runner at second. The 0-2. Swing and a ball served on the ground. Foul outside of third. Nothing else. Stevenson trying to put together a good at bat here. 0-2 is the count. Lewis's lead off second. Loop checks the runner. From the stretch, he kicks and fires. Cut on, foul tip. Held by the catcher Jennings. Did he hold it? I thought I saw home plate umpire Drew Hoglund say that he held it for the strikeout, but now Drew is saying, nope, that's a foul ball. He dropped it. And here comes Gary Gaetti again from the first base dugout. It looked like from up here Jennings held the baseball, but Gary Gaetti wants an appeal to third. Are they going to get one? I think they should if it's in question, no? I don't know. Gary Gaetti is finished with his meeting with Drew Hoglund, the home plate umpire. As it is, it's nothing and two. Fred Lewis had a quick word with third base coach Jeremy Owens. He's back at second, taking his lead. Outfielders play straight away. Hit to the outfield, should be able to score Lewis. Remember, Almonte, good arm in center. Russo, good arm in right. The set position, outside target. Now a fake throw to second, chasing Lewis back to the bag. Stevenson, before that pitch, inched up in the batter's box. The set position, the 0-2. Cut on, fouled straight back to the screen. Stevenson not going away here at all easy. Eaters have lost six of their last seven. And look to salvage this series and take a game here tonight. Nobody out, runner at second here in the bottom of the ninth, no score. The 0-2. Swinging a ground ball to the right side. To his left is Young. He gloves it. And he throws on to first base. Stevenson out. Just as good as a sacrifice bunt, though. Runner at second base pulls the ball on the ground and gets Lewis over to third. Now the go-ahead run, the winning run 90 feet away. Here's Casey Frawley. Brawley tonight is 0 for 2 with a sack bunt. He'll be intentionally walked to set up the double play. Now let's see here. Will the middle infielders go back for the double play? Or will they stay up? Everybody is up on the infield right now, about 2 feet behind the grass. DeJesus, remember, if you want to play for the double play, fine. But DeJesus is a guy who has a lot of speed coming out of that left-handed batter's box. So the infielders here, it appears, will stay up, maybe not. So Palmero is about 2 feet behind the grass at third. Middle infielders are playing basically directly in the baseline right now with the shortstop Weems and Young, the second baseman. And the first baseman, Scott, is holding on Frawley. The pitch to DeJesus. Anton takes a little bit low. Lewis is at third, Frawley at first. DeJesus tonight is 1 for 4 with a single and a stolen base. Lefty on lefty matchup with one out. Reddy Ozuna waits to hit next. Luke, middle of the rubber, brings the hands together. The 1-0. Taken for a called strike over the outside corner. The Skeeters will take on York at home in a four-game set this weekend. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, and then hit the road again to take on Lancaster next week. The 1-1. Up high, 2-1. Infielders now have creeped in. I guess a ground ball here to the middle infielders or one of the infielders. You know, I guess it's up to them. Hey, if you want the double play, take it if you think you can get it. If not, come home. The 2-1. Swung on, popped him up, foul. Right around the home plate area. Jennings, the catcher, throws off the mask and makes a one-hand catch just shy of the track. The Jesus popping out, and there's two away. Luke looking to work out of this jam, and he's one batter away. Here's Renny Ozuna, right-handed hitter. And Gary Gaetti goes to the bullpen here. There is activity down the right field line. Gary will do just that. He's going to get the right-hander. We've got another pitch and change. Bottom of the ninth inning, no score. Lewis is the runner at third. Ferrelli is the runner at first. Blue Crabs trying to win their eighth straight. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. John Lujan is the new pitcher, right-hander. Auto relief for Derek Loop. Here's the situation, no score, bottom nine. Fred Lewis is the runner at third. Casey Ferrelli the runner at first, two down. Lewis led off the inning with a single. Ferrelli then grounded out to second base to move Lewis over from second to third. And then an intentional walk issue. By the way, Lewis moved over to second on the balk by Loop. Ferrelli intentionally walked, and DeJesus popping out and foul ground to the catcher, Jennings. Blue Crab look to win their eighth straight. Ozuna the batter. Two outs. Here's the pitch. Rennie takes a called strike across the knees. Ozuna tonight is one for four. Great game here tonight. Luke went two-thirds of an inning. Pitch. Swung on, fouled straight back to the screen with Ferrelli running from first and it's 0-2. Nobody appeared to be breaking for second to cover the bag. Ferrelli may be off again. 0-2 is the count. Lujan 6'1", 230 pounds from Waco, Texas. The set position. The kick, the 0-2. Swing and a fly ball left center field into the gap play. Over to his left goes Martin. And the left fielder makes the snag for out number three. Blue Crabs stranding 11 base runners here tonight. No runs, a hit, one walk, and one man left. We head to the 10th inning. No score, Skeeters, Blue Crabs, on the Intrepid Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network. Top half of the 10th inning. No score, Skeeters, Blue Crabs here at Regency Furniture Stadium. Game three of this three-game set. Blue Crabs have won seven straight. Skeeters have dropped six of their last seven. And we've got free baseball here tonight in Southern Maryland. Game three of this three-game set. Jake Hale finished nine innings of work. Five hits, one walk, eight Ks. Justin Berg, the right-hander, is the new pitcher. Denny Almonte will lead off, 6-7-8. Almonte, Scott Palmero. Here's the pitch. Swings and lines it in left center field. That's down, a base hit on two hops. DeJesus fielding it in the gap. Big turnaround first by DeJesus. And the sixth hit of the night for the Skeeters. DeJesus one for four, or rather Almonte, excuse me. Four for four in stolen bases this season. He is at first. A running threat here is Travis Scott. Justin Berg, eight games this year, nine and a third, two runs, eight hits, five walks, nine strikeouts, 1-1 on the season. 0.96 ERA, deals a fastball down and in to the left-handed hitting Travis Scott, who's one for three here tonight. Sugar Land with four runners left on here tonight. They put two runners on in the fourth. It's really been their only threat. The set, the kick, the 1-0. Almonte breaks for second. Here's a swing and a looper out to shallow center field. DeJesus coming on. It touches down onto the grass. A base hit. Almonte not stopping. Gets into third base standing. Runners at the corners off back-to-back singles. And here's Patrick Palmero with a chance to put the Skeeters ahead here late, top of the 10th inning, no score. Seven hits apiece for both of these clubs. Palmero is one for three in the game with a single in the third. Remember, at one point in this ballgame, Jake Hale, the starter, retired 13 straight. Skeeters looking to end this winning streak, though, of the Blue Crabs. And a big win it would be. First of all, it would turn things around a little bit. A team that has lost six of their last seven. And are trying to end this mini road trip on a right note. There's a swing and a foul tip into the mid of Molina. And a big positive it would be if they can take a win away from the Blue Crabs here tonight. It'd certainly be a nice, pleasant plane ride home. Palmero, right-handed hitter. Berg, first base edge of the rubber. Justin comes set. The kick and the pitch. Swung on, hit in the air, right center field, should get the run in. DeJesus to his left into the gap. Antone makes a one-hand catch. Tagging from third, Almonte, the throw offline. It skips by Molina. And all the way to the backstop, Berg there to back it up. The throw offline, halfway up the third base line as Almonte scores standing. Palmero with his ninth RBI of the year. And it's 1-0 Skeeters here in the top of the 10th. One out, runner at first base, and Scott. Here is Todd Jennings, who is 0 for 3. So Justin Berg allowing a run, and I should say his first run, his last six appearances. Make it seven now. There's a fastball down low for ball one. Here's the set position. The kick and the 1-0. Cut on, fouled straight back to the brick backstop. One ball and one strike is the count. Jennings, the number 9 hitter, right-handed hitting catcher. Two hits in the inning. A run in, top 10, 1-0 Skeeters. The 1-1. Swing and a miss on a pitch in the dirt. Kicks by Molina slightly to the backstop, towards the backstop, onto the grass, I should say. Gustavo quickly on it, back to first. Goes Scott, who really didn't have a good read on that pitch. As Jennings was fooled, swinging and missing. Down the count, 1-2, stands back in, right-handed batter's box. Outside of his back right foot, up against the back chalk line. Berg steps off the backside of the rubber. Big hole on the right side. and Stevenson pinched towards the second base bag. Burke set up the belt. The 1-2. Swung on, pushed foul first base side off the dugout fence. Jennings getting jammed ever so slightly. Fouling it off, still 1-2. Bullpen activity down the left field line for the Blue Crabs. Bird comes set. The 1-2. Swing and a line drive. Right center field to Jesus on his horse into the gap. Makes a one-hand catch in stride. Nice play by the center fielder. Jennings 0-for-4. Back to first goes Scott. Back to the top of the order we go. Here's Kevin Russo. Kevin tonight 0-for-4. Skeeters lead it 1-0, top 10. Run in on two hits. Here's the pitch. Russo, right-handed hitter, takes a strike. Skeeters a team, the first and only Atlantic League team outside of the Northeast. Looking to pick up the win tonight here in the Northeast. The 0-1. Cut on, a foul tip at the plate, it's 0-2. Russo, former 20th round draft pick by the Yankees from Baylor in 06. Fought up for the first time by the Yankees, May 8th of 2010. The guy who sat out the entire year last year. Bird comes set. The 0-2 runner breaks for second. Pitch up and away. Molina's throw to second. A little bit wide to the right field side of the bag. It skips into center. DeJesus backs it up. As Scott's sliding in feed first safely with the stolen base. First of the year for Travis. One ball and two strikes is the count. Molina, a quick word with Justin Berg. Berg, the 6'3", 225-pound right-hander. Antigo, Wisconsin. Out of the bullpen, first pitcher. On relief for Stan Clyburn's team tonight. Jake Hale, 9 innings tonight. 8 strikeouts, 1 walk. Great start from Jake. 1-2. Swing and a fly ball in the air. Shallow right. Coming on is Lewis. He dives head first, and he can't make the play. Scott around 30 will score. Into second base goes Russo with a stand-up double. It's a good effort there by Fred Lewis, but it's a double for Russo, his fifth of the year. The RBI, his fifth as well. Two runs in for the Skeeters here in the 10th. They lead it 2-0. And here comes Stan Clyburn. Justin Berg is finished. And we've got our orthopedic sports and physical therapy call to the bullpen. We've got a new pitcher coming in for the Blue Crabs. Two runs in for the Skeeters on 3 hits here in the top of the 10th inning. They lead it 2-0 on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Thank you. Orthopedic sports and physical therapy call to the bullpen. Orlando Santos is the new pitcher. Justin Berg finished 2/3 of an inning. 2 runs, 3 hits. Skeeters lead it 2-0, top 10. Kevin Russo with a double, an RBI to score Travis Scott from second base. A little looper to right that Lewis dove and couldn't make the play. Patrick Palomero, a sacrifice fly here in the inning to score Elmonte. Elmonte and Scott with back-to-back hits. Runners at first and third, and Palomero with a sacrifice fly RBI. Two batters later, Russo a double. Here's Weems' pitch. Swing and a miss. And the right-handed pitcher, rather, Santos, dealing a fastball. Up in the zone, Weems chasing. Beamer tonight 0-for-3. He was hit by a pitch back in the first. Santos, the third pitcher of the Knights for Stan Clyburn's team. ERA of over 8 this year, 0-1 record. The 0-1. Outside, 1-1. At times he has struggled to throw strikes. He's walked 4 batters overall this season. Opponents hitting .273 off Orlando. Here's the set. Now the 1-1. Outside. 2-1 is the count. The Blue Crabs in the bottom of the 10th will have Wilson, Hankert, and Molina come to the plate. Part of their order, 3-4-5. We'll see who will come out of the bullpen, if anybody, or Sugar Land. The 2-1. Cut on, foul tip in and out of the mid of Molina, 2-2. Two balls, 2 strikes, Santos middle of the rubber, leaning at the waist. The lead by Russo at second base. Outfielders shade slightly towards right center. The kick, the 2-2. Swing and a soft liner out towards short to his left, Frawley. Fields on a bounce. Sidearms to first, and it's in time for out number 3 as Weems getting jammed and grounding out to Casey Frawley. The Skeeters, though, take the lead. 2 runs, 3 hits, no errors, 1 man left in scoring position. We head to the bottom of the 10th inning. Last chance coming up for the Blue Crabs. It'll be Wilson, Hanker, and Molina against the right-hander, John Lujan. We'll step aside, bottom of the 10th, Skeeters up 2-0 on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Chance coming up for the Blue Crabs. Bottom half of the 10th inning. Skeeters up 2-0. 2 runs in the top of the 10th inning on 3 hits. Palomero with a sacrifice fly to score Denny Elmonte. And then a couple of batters later, Kevin Russo, the leadoff hitter for Sugar Land, with the double to score Travis Scott from second base. And the Skeeters put up a 2-spot in the top of the 10th. It'll be Wilson, Hankert, and Molina here in the bottom of the 10th. John Lujan, his second inning of work. Wilson tonight, 2-for-4 with 2 singles. Here's the set position. Now the kick and the first offer. Wilson, right-handed hitter, takes a strike across the knees. Skeeters, 2 runs, 8 hits. Blue Crabs with 7 hits, and they've left 11 runners on base here tonight. They had a chance to win it in the bottom of the ninth, but left 2 more on. Here's the set. The kick, the 0-1. Swung on, chopped foul of third, it's 0-2. Justin Berg was charged with a run given up in the top half of the 10th inning. And it's really a shame because this bullpen for the Blue Crabs that went 1-3 in April has gone 3-0 here in May. The 0-2 offering. Swing and a line drive back up the middle, out of the range of Delwin Young in the center field, a base hit. Zipped right past the outstretched glove of the second baseman, Delwin Young. And it's a leadoff single for Zach Wilson. Here is Kyle Hanker. Finish my thought on the bullpen for the Blue Crabs. Here in May, 3-0, a 1.27 ERA as compared to a 1-3 record in April with a 6.84 ERA. Kyle Hanker tonight is 0-3. He was hit by a pitch in the 8th. Right-handed hitter. Nobody out. 2-0 Skeeters, bottom 10. Here's the kick and the pitch. Taken low. Skeeters coming in, having lost 6 of their last 7. Blue Crabs have won 7 in a row, looking for their second straight sweep. They swept the Revolution last weekend in 4 games. 1-0. Swing and a drive. Deep left center field. Going back is Martin. Almonte onto the track. At the wall. It's gone. A 2-run walk-off home run. Kyle Hanker. And the Blue Crabs have won it here tonight. Oh, I'm sorry. It's a 2-run shot to tie the game. Kyle Hanker just tied the game. Hanker with his second home run here this series. And we're all knotted at 2 here in the bottom of the 10th. Here's Gustavo Molina. We're tied at 2. Here's the pitch. Taken for a called strike over the outside corner. My apologies, I got ahead of myself. All tied at 2, and the Blue Crabs coming back here in the bottom of the 10th. Here's the kick and the pitch. Swing, and he popped him up along the left field line. Back from third, Palomero crossing into foul ground. Right in front of the bullpen metal benches. And the third baseman, Patrick, makes a one-hand catch. And Molina fouling out. Here's Darryl Ward. Ward is 0-4 tonight. Kyle Hanker tying the game with a 2-run home run here in the bottom of the 10th. There's the kick and the pitch. Check swing, called strike over the outside. Hanker with that home run to left center field. Here's the set. Now the 0-1. Swing and a line drive into right. That's down in front of Russo for a base hit. Third hit here in the bottom of the 10th inning for the Blue Crabs. Here's Fred Lewis, who is 1-4. Jamar Walton will come on as a pinch runner for Darryl Ward. Appears as though we will have another pitching change. We will. Gary Gaetti going to his bullpen. Wuhan had a chance to closed this thing down for the Skeeters, gave up a game-tying home run to Kyle Hanker, and we've got another pitching change. All tied at two, bottom of the 10th. One on, one out. Fred Lewis will be the batter on the Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Bottom 10, 2-2 is the score. One out. Fred Lewis the batter. Corey Van Allen, new pitcher. Here's the pitch. Lewis takes outside. Jamar Walton is the pinch runner at first. Darryl Ward singling. Kyle Hanker tying the game here in the bottom of the 10th with a two-run home run. Here's the set. Now a quick throw to first, and Walton diving back in head first safely. Lewis tonight is 1-for-2 with a single in the ninth and two walks. The pitch taken for a called strike over the outer third. Van Allen this season, 3-0, with two strikeouts. Opponents are hitting under 100 against him. Another throw to first. Walton diving back in, head first safely to the back inside corner of the bag. Allen comes set, the lefty deal. Cut on, foul tip into the mitt of Jennings. And it's 1-2. There's the set position. The 1-2. Outside, two balls and two strikes. Now the set. Pickoff throw to first. And Walton back in safely standing. That throw wide. The back inside part of the bag. It pulled Scott right off. Van Allen is the fifth pitcher of the night. Lujan went 2/3 of an inning. 2 runs, 3 hits. 2-2. Just missed a little bit low. Full count. Van Allen, 6'3", 180-pounder from Sugar Land, Texas. Playing right in his hometown for the Skeeters. Here's the set. Walton is lead off first, breaks for second. Payoff inside, ball four. Lewis walking for the third time here tonight. Runners at first and second. Here's Casey Stevenson. And Allen 3-0 on the year. Pitched against the Blue Crabs at the bullpen last night. Went an inning. Struck out two. First and second. The pitch. Outside, ball one. 10 hits in the game for the Blue Crabs. 8 hits in the game for the Skeeters. Both teams with 2 runs. And both teams scoring those 2 runs in the 10th. The 1-0. Taken for a called strike at the belt. Stevenson tonight, 0-for-3 with a sack bunt. There's the set position with one out. The kick and the pitch. Down the way, 2 balls and 1 strike. From the stretch, the 2-1. There's a strike, a fastball over the outside corner. Gallagher started the game, 7 innings, 5 hits, 2 walks, 6 strikeouts. Weinhardt, Luke Lujan, now Van Allen, all out of the bullpen tonight for Gary Gaetti's team. Corey set at the belt, checks the runner at second. 1 out. The 2-2 on the way. Swung on, bounced foul of first. And Allen drafted by the Nationals in the 5th round of the 06 draft from Baylor. Allen brings the hands together, first and second, 1 out. The 2-2. Check swing, flare, foul. Third base side out of play. Fastball that got in tight on Stevenson. Checked his swing, fouling it away. Walton pinch running for Ward, he's at second base. Fred Lewis walking, 3 walks tonight issued to Fred. He's at first base. Outfielders play straight away. Set position. The kick, the 2-2. Swing and a soft liner into right center field. That falls down for a base hit. Walton's being waved around third. He will score without a play. Casey Stevenson wins it here in the bottom of the 10th for the Blue Crabs. A walk-off single. And Southern Maryland picks up the 3-2 victory here tonight. And they've won 8 straight. Stevenson getting that one off the end of the bat. A soft liner that fell in for a base hit. And the Blue Crabs have won 8 straight. They sweep the Sugar Land Skeeters here tonight. The final 3-2. Back with the totals after this. An exciting one here tonight at Regency Furniture Stadium. This is the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs Baseball Network, powered by Intrepid. Yeah.
Just let me know when you're ready to do your post-game recap.
Why are you laughing, by the way? When I came out, you're laughing.
Oh, no, I was just saying good job. And then the battery's coming up. It's like, you better get back on.
You never said good job to me, ever. You caught me off guard. I didn't... Well, the Blue Crabs win it tonight in walk-off fashion by the final of 3-2. Kyle Hanker tying the game in the bottom of the 10th with a two-run home run over the wall in left center field. And then Casey Stevenson a few batters later with the game-winning single here tonight in the bottom of the 10th. And the Blue Crabs win it by...